Oh, no. Oh, wait. That was bad planning. I should have put the little sign in there so it'd be just like the opening credits of Will It Waffle. Aw, dang it. Well, hello, everyone who is here watching Will It Waffle. Let me just go open up the comments really quick so I can see what you're all saying in here. Let's see here. Even though there's a lag, so you're probably not saying anything yet. Welcome to live Will It Waffle. I was about to say the first ever live Will It Waffle, but it's not the first ever live Will It Waffle. I did a live Will It Waffle at LeakyCon this year, and it was pretty awesome. I had a lot of fun. This is my first time doing a live Will It Waffle on like a hangout on the internet. So we'll see how this goes. I do have to say that I tried really hard for like a month. Like, no joke, to try and figure out how to connect my DSLR to do a hangout. And hold on, it says there's no viewers. I wonder if that just hasn't updated. Everyone, let me know if you're seeing this. I know there's like a lag, but let me know if you can see this when you can. It's really weird doing this by yourself. I always do hangouts with like a bunch of other people. But when you're by yourself, you're very uncertain. Like, is this actually broadcasting? Is it going to the right place? I don't know. Oh yeah, it looks like it is. Okay, cool. Awesome. Bela Han asks if everyone got their waffles, which is true. In my last video, I made a rule that while you're watching Will It Waffle videos, you must be eating a waffle. So everyone, go take your computer to the kitchen, be careful. Make some waffles, and you gotta eat waffles for this whole broadcast. I don't know how long it's gonna be, so you better make a lot of waffles, because that's the new rule for Will It Waffle. No, what I was saying is, I tried really hard to figure out how to connect my DSLR, like my good camera, to a hangout, and you kind of can, but not really, it doesn't really work. So we're gonna be using my computer, my eyesight camera, to do this, and so you might not see the waffles too well. I can move the camera to them, but you know, it's not very HD, so I apologize. I will try to commentate to you and let you know as best I can what's going on with the waffles, since you won't be able to see too well. Also, let me know in the comments if the audio sounds all right. Usually I have like a mic and headphones, but I'm gonna be running all over the kitchen, so I can't do that. So hopefully it sounds all right. I think most of you who are watching right now have come from Ivana Lynch's hangout, which is funny that I'm coming just right after her. Like, cool, what a letdown after having just watched freaking Ivana Lynch. Now go watch some nerd in their kitchen waffling things. That's, yeah, those were the only times in both of our schedules that worked, was her at 7 and me at 8:30 tonight. So it just worked out that way. I feel really weird about being after Ivana Lynch. So if you don't know who I am and you're just coming from that hangout, thank you. That's really cool of you. So let me just, for people who either don't know who I am and what Will It Waffle is or don't know what the fundraiser is, before we dive into the waffles, let me just quickly explain both things. So my name is Lauren. I do a show on YouTube on this channel that you're watching. It's called Will It Waffle. And basically, I put things on a waffle iron and see what happens. That's really all there is to it. It's not a very complicated show. It's not really a science show because I don't know anything about science, and it's not really a cooking show because I don't give you recipes or anything like that. I don't do anything to the food, I just throw it on. And it's not really a comedy show because it's not that funny. So I don't know why you guys are watching this, frankly. but thank you. And tonight we are here for the Harry Potter Alliance's Equality for the Win fundraiser. As you can see right there, equality, wow, this is mirrored, that's hard. Equalityftw.org. If you forget at any point during the fundraiser, it's down here and it's also back there. That's the name of the fundraiser. That's where you can go to donate. Equality for the Win is the annual fundraiser for the Harry Potter Alliance. Harry Potter Alliance is a nonprofit that turns fans into heroes. They do a lot of really awesome things, taking fans and fandoms, and also people who are just generally fans of story, and using their enthusiasm and their knowledge of story and like parallels from the story to do good in our world. And they've done a lot of awesome things, but I'll talk about that a lot more later, because I want to get into waffling stuff now. I've been talking a lot. You really realize how much you talk when there's no one else on the hangout with you. Oh boy, I'm going to be sick of the sound of my voice real soon. Like 10 years ago I was. Anyways, so what's going on tonight is that for the last like 24 hours since yesterday, we had a perk up on the Indiegogo where people could buy a perk and see and tell me to waffle something, like anything they want, and I will waffle it. Because usually I kind of just do whatever I want, and people always leave suggestions, but I don't necessarily do it right away. So this was a cool opportunity to give to charity and also force me to do something that they've always been wanting me to do. So we've got at least three planned out that we're going to do tonight. And you can actually donate still. And if you choose something that is in my house that I currently have, so like normal things, then I will also waffle it. So you can still force me to waffle something. We might waffle more than three things if anyone still wants to donate. I guess just like be open to maybe needing to choose your second choice thing if you want to buy that tonight, or maybe I'll try to keep an eye on the comments. Actually, as I say that, let me just tell one of my friends to watch the comments for me and say, if anyone is asking about something I have in my house to waffle, can you let me know? And then I'll know to let them know, and then they know they can donate for it. Cool. All right, let's get waffling. and as I'm waffling, just remember to check out the Equality for the Win campaign if you haven't been around all night tonight already checking it out. And please do let people know that you're watching this and tell them to come join this hangout, because hopefully it'll be fun. Let's get into it. So the first thing that we're going to waffle tonight, I am the first one I've decided to do is because the person who donated for it actually lives in the Netherlands, and it is very, very late there. It's even later than it was for Ivana. So I want to do theirs first so that she can go to bed. So the first person who donated was Hilda, who is the chapter organizer, I think, or the president of our Dutch and Belgian chapter, the Harry Potter Alliance's Dutch and Belgian chapter. Hilda is one of the coolest people I know. And Hilda told me, so she sent me a list of things that I could choose to waffle. Here's the first thing that she said. She said, you know how there was this thing where people used to waffle their hair to make it all zigzaggy? She did not tell me to waffle my hair, thankfully, but I thought that's where this was going at first. She proceeds to say, you don't have to waffle your hair. Thank you, Hilda. Thank you for not making me waffle my hair. To be honest, if my hair were like long enough to put on a waffle iron, I might try it. My mom would kill me, but I think it would be cool to see what happens. But what Hilda actually said was maybe it would be cool to waffle something similar to hair, so some food that would get that like crimping effect when you waffle it. So she suggested spaghetti, perhaps, or cotton candy, or as Hilda said, candy floss. I think in Europe they maybe call it candy floss. But we are going to waffle some cotton candy. I'm pretty excited about this. I had to like Google where to buy cotton candy because I didn't know like where you buy it, not at a festival. Oh my gosh, and I also just realized that I have not warmed up any of my waffle irons right now. So we're going to have to do a bit more of the boring talking. Maybe I'll look in the comments in a second. Let me just think really quick which waffle iron I want to use for which. You guys want to see, this is my arrangement of waffle irons here. As well as the Surge that I've been drinking. So this waffle iron that we're warming up right now, this is my trusty waffle iron. This is the one that you see in most of my videos. I had one just like it in season one, but it actually broke at LeakyCon this year, and maybe I'll tell you that story a bit later. But yeah, I brought another one exactly like it, and this is the one I've been using in season two. This waffle iron, it's not as good. It has bigger irons. You can see this is what in America we refer to as a Belgian style. Smaller irons, both for actual waffles and for Will It Waffle, because when you're waffling weird things, kind of the fun part is to get those waffle scorch marks. So when there's more scorch marks you can get on the iron, it's just more entertaining. So I prefer those. So I have only used this one in one episode with Karen Cavett when we waffled Oreos, because at the time it was the only one in my possession. And then we have this waffle iron. This is one of those kinds that you see in like colleges and hotels where it's supposed to flip like that. It flips. It is also a Belgian style one. My friends actually got me that for my birthday because they know that I go through a lot of waffle irons. And the thing is, since it's like, it's not the kind of irons I like and it's so big and clunky, I decided that I'm never going to use it for Will It Waffle. I'll use it just for real waffles because my roommate was getting a little annoyed that I was waffling weird things on our waffle iron. And when we wanted to make real waffles, they tasted like Peeps and sushi. So I was like, all right, this waffle iron will be just for normal waffles. So no one tell her that I'm waffling something weird on it tonight, all right? Between you and me. All right, let me just check out the comments really quick before we dive into this. See how many people I've scared away. What would happen if you just waffled pure sugar for an hour? Actually, I can pretty much imagine. It'll just kind of like harden, it'll like crystallize and harden and kind of disappear pretty much. It'll just kind of evaporate. We're not doing it for an hour, but we're pretty close to finding out the answer to that for like 2 minutes, because that's pure sugar is basically what cotton candy is. Oh good, Hilda is here. Mega Minecraft Fan 101 asks, can you see mobile comments? If you made that comment on a mobile device, then the answer is yes. Fourth year says they think that cotton candy is going to turn directly into smoke. I kind of think that might happen too. That reminds me to turn on my vent. But that's actually why I wanted to do it. I thought it might be fun and cool like that. Let's see. Athena McGonagall sympathizes with nerds waffling in their kitchens. Audio sounds good. Okay, cool. Your comments are awesome. Keep your comments coming. I'll try to keep an eye on them. And just again, if you want to recommend something for me to waffle tonight, you can donate for the Will It Waffle perk. It has just been added back to the campaign page at equalityftw.org. And some of the HPA staff is keeping an eye on the comments if you want to double check if I have on hand what you want me to waffle before you donate for it. Or if you have several things you'd be happy with, kind of anything, then you can go ahead and donate and just, I guess, email me. Someone let me know if the perks are bought really quick so I can know. Claudia, when you hear this, just like I am me, if any Will It Waffle perks get bought. Because in addition to getting me to waffle anything you want tonight, I also put up another perk that I believe is up there right now. I'll go get it after we do this first waffle to show you an example. But some of you might know that if you see me at conferences or run into me at other events, I have buttons of Will It Waffle. Got little happy and sad buttons in all different colors, and a lot of people have asked me if I can sell them online. The answer is usually no, because, you know, they're just buttons and shipping. It would be very expensive if I did that all the time. But because tonight is a special night and it's for charity, it's for the Harry Potter Alliance, I am for one night only putting those buttons up for sale online. So no matter where you live, I will send a happy and a sad button to you. They're up for $10 on the fundraiser right now at EqualityFTW. I know that's kind of a lot for buttons, but it is for charity, and this is the only night you can get them without seeing me in person, because that's usually the only way, is if you happen to run into me, is usually the only way you can get these buttons. So go look at all of that. Go tell your friends about that. But right now, we are going to waffle cotton candy, which is something I've never even thought about waffling, so this is pretty cool. I'm pretty excited. I'm not entirely sure what to do with my laptop here, though. Maybe for now we'll do this, so you can just see the waffle iron. Ooh, and not me. All right. Let's see. Put a little bit of cooking spray on this, just in case. I'm looking at my waffle iron right now. Wow, my head is really close to that. What if I accidentally waffled my face? What a scar that would be. I don't want that. But that would be kind of cool, right? Like a waffle scar on your face, battle scars. All right, I'm weird, I'm sorry, but I think that would be cool. Put that there for now. Got cooking spray everywhere. All right. So while this is waffling, everyone give your predictions down in the comments of what you think is going to happen. Most people are saying it's going to be like the jam episode again, turn to smoke, think it'll burn. I'm going to be pretty delicate with this, actually. I've got it on the lowest setting, and I really just want to see, like, wow, this looks like a tribble or something. I just want to see, like, some delicate waffle patterns on it. Maybe we'll just do, like, half. Oh, God, guys, I gotta say, I do not like cotton candy. It's too sugary for me. I've never liked eating it, but I forgot until this moment that I actually used to be terrified of touching it. I'm not scared right now, but, this is weird. I've probably only touched cotton candy a handful of times in my entire life. This is very bizarre to me right now. And I'm learning, as I'm holding this, that there's kind of a bit of a tough outer shell, which might protect it a little bit when we waffle it. This cotton candy, by the way, was made in-house today at Dylan's Candy Bar in Manhattan. They're a great candy reseller, but I called them to ask if they sell cotton candy. I thought they might like have a bucket, and they were like, yes, we make it in-house every day. I'm like, dang, this is like artisanal cotton candy here. All right, moment of truth. Get that out of the way, out of the shot. Ugh. Ooh. All right, I wish I had a better webcam. I'm sorry. Okay, I'll shut up. Let's do this. Oh no, oh, it's dying. It's just, oh, what? That is, wow, I might take that off in like 2 seconds. Oh boy. I don't know, I know it doesn't really have any like density to it at all. It's really light, but I still sort of thought it wouldn't sink that much. Jeezy crazy. Oh, see, it thinks it's done already. Oh, you can't see. The little green light came on. So, all right, let's definitely check this. Can you guys, sure we can see? Oh my gosh, that was fast. Oh my God, guys, that was like instantaneous. Okay, you might not realize because I usually cut this stuff out. Like, that's as fast as it looks in an edited video sometimes, how fast that was. But like, sometimes I am sitting here for ages waiting for things to waffle. Anyone who might be in the comments or watching who has been around when I've been waffling, you know this, because I always have to apologize to people when I'm collabing. I'm like, yeah, this is the bit I usually cut out of a video because it's so boring. That was so fast! Whoa, wait, let's do it again. I wanna try it again, because that's why I left like this other big, massive, all right. Red, look at that, looks so cool. I'm so glad I went for blue. Oh, this is cool. Okay, round two, we're gonna do this. Because see, now there's some sticking out, so whoa, okay, it's just that's to say what's gonna happen. That was such a clean cut. That was actually beautiful because it was like the heat of the iron just sliced through it. Oh, whoa. And already it's there. I don't know if you could see, there were some strings that came through it. Oh my gosh, that was so ridiculously fast. I can't even, guys. I cannot even. Wow. All right, so I'm reading your comments right now, but I don't know if you guys have gotten to what I've just done yet. That was just so cool. I loved it. Have any of you seen I'm asking that like if you have watched my episode with John Green, which is the most recent episode, I think that's up. Wow, this is still sizzling. I take a little. In that episode, John remarks that Will It Waffle is not a joke for me. I genuinely like it, and I think you guys just got a first look at how ridiculously tickled I am by waffling things. Like, that was way too exciting for me. Oh my gosh. It's just the bright blue makes it so exciting. All right, I'm going to go to the comments right now before we get to the next waffle. Let me just check. A little bit talk about buttons. A couple of people saying how they tried to get buttons from me at LeakyCon. I was always distracted and didn't have them on me and they never got any. Yes, I'm sorry about that. That happened a lot at LeakyCon, there were a lot of times people asked me and I had run out or something. So if you do want buttons, tonight's the night. I will send them to you and you'll have buttons. I don't know. I've got so many buttons here, so I will send you a happy one and a sad one. I'll run and get those in a moment, but the little logo dude that I have up here on my lower third, that's basically what they look like. Oh, Tyler Starr says he just came to watch Will It Waffle, didn't even watch Ivana. I mean, I can't be too happy about it. I'm flattered, but, you know, Ivana's amazing. I love her. And I unfortunately missed her hangout, and I'm sad that I missed it. Hilda says, it looks like a Smurf exploded on your waffle iron. And yeah, it does. Hilda, I'm sorry that that didn't have the... I really thought if I just left it on for like 5 seconds, that would happen. But nope. Mm-mm. This is all that's left, is the bit that was sliced off. It's like, fits on my face perfect. Oh, look, what if these are like my sideburns? That'd be Papa Smurf. That's cool. I'm not eating that. I do not like cotton candy. Not gonna eat that. I'm really glad that this actually just disintegrated, because it means I don't have to eat it. That's one thing about Will It Waffle, is that I waffle a lot of things that I do not care to eat. That's a couple of insider tricks, secrets for you guys here. When I don't want to eat something that I've decided I should waffle, or you guys have suggested I should waffle, that's usually when I pull out a buddy to do a collab video so that they can taste it. That was one of the reasons that Taryn was on the QuesadillaCon video, because we used real cheese and I can't eat cheese. All right, going back to the comments. Burn, get hard. Lauren could be Harry Potter with a new scar, a waffle scar. That would be pretty cool. speaking of me being Harry Potter, let me just check if this perk is still up there. I think there is a perk. Yeah, there is still a perk on the Indiegogo page at equalityftw.org, where if you are going to GeekyCon next year, you can actually have tea with a bunch of Harry Potters, one of which is played by one of my alter egos. There are two things that I do on YouTube. I waffle things and I pretend to be Harry Potter. It's a weird life. Someone's got to do it, I guess. But anyways, if you would like to have tea with Harry Potter, as well as Harry Potter and his friend Harry Potter and Harry Potter, then you can do that by donating to Equality for the Win. Go to equalityforthewin.org, and there is a perk to have tea with Harry Potter. And it looks like no one has bought it so far, but that is actually not true. It sold out already. It sold out during the GeekyCon hangout, and so we had to put up a new one because we decided we want to have tea with more friends. So it looks like it's unpopular. It's actually not. You should go buy it so we have tea with lots of people, and if you want, you can cosplay as Cho Chang, and we'll make it super awkward for you. It'll probably be awkward no matter what, because I'll be there. But, you know. All right. I just thought I'd go over some of the perks there first. But let's see. Got two more things to waffle so far. I just want to check if we have anything else we might waffle tonight. Waffle some hot dogs, says Mint Sprinkles. You know, my roommate has hot dogs right now. I could waffle hot dogs, but only if you donate to equalityftw.org. The Harry Potter Alliance actually put some magical locks on my waffle irons, and they won't work unless there is a donation associated with them. And I actually, you know what? I haven't been checking what Equality for the Win is like, because this is part of a fundraiser. We should be raising money. I don't know how much we were at when we started. Let me just ask. How much money did we start at? Because I want to try to incentivize some things here for you guys, maybe. Oh, it looks like three people have claimed buttons. You guys are the best. Let me go check out who you are so I can thank you. Sarah, Alyssa, and Megan, thank you guys so much. I will... I'll probably like email you later to see what colors you want. you guys want to take a tour right now, actually, it's not really going to be a tour. I'm not going to tell you anything, but I want to get these buttons so that you can see. And when you're doing a solo hangout, you can't just be like, hey, dude, why don't you cover while I go grab something? Because there is no other dude on here. You just have to do it by yourself. Aha! I have waffle buttons. See what I mean? There's so many in here. So many of you could buy this perk. Because when you buy the perk, you get a happy and a sad. That's only two buttons. Look how many you could buy. I have so many. Okay. Let me get these out to show you. I'm being told... All right, so we were around $104,400 when we started. We've made $400 already? Seriously? Is that true? What have you guys been donating for? That's pretty awesome. I'm very proud of us right now. That's great. I should start setting some goals so we can celebrate how awesome we are when we raise that much money. Another thing to let you know about Equality for the Win tonight is that all of the donations are actually being matched, which means that we have this awesome group of people called the Order of the Phoenix. That is what we're calling them. It's just a group of really, really nice philanthropists who are nice enough to donate some money to Equality for the Win. So for the next $13,000, I don't know how much has been donated already, but for a period of time, when you donate, you actually get donate twice, essentially, because they are matching your donation. So if you donate to get a Will It Waffle button, or two buttons, for $10, it's actually $20 to Equality for the Win because they're matching your donation. So you should definitely do that while the match is up, which will probably only be like until tomorrow or something. So this is the time to donate. It's also because the fundraiser is ending on Saturday, so it is really the time to donate. And I'm helping to run this fundraiser, so I know how cool all of these perks are. All right, here are some buttons so that you can see. This is what some of the buttons look like. There is an awful glare, but you can kind of see. This mirrored thing. You would think, like, after so many years on YouTube, you get used to, like, mirrored screens. You so don't. It's just, you never get used to it. Okay, there's also green. So we got green and blue and orange, which does not look orange on this Hangout screen, and pink. And there's also some rare purples. And they're in the Happy Waffle or the Waffle, awful with a W. And so when you donate, you will get a happy and you will get a sad. And I'll actually email you and ask what colors you want and do the best. And again, usually you can only get these like if you run into me somewhere at a conference, or I keep a few in my backpack if I, you know, go to weird nerdy events in New York City that people are at. So, you know, if you haven't ever been to one of those or missed me, this is your one night to get them. And thank you to Sarah, Megan, and Alyssa, who have already bought them, because that is super awesome. And also, if you want to donate for me to waffle something, you can also do that tonight. We're waffling a couple of things already. We're going to get back to waffling soon. I know I've been talking for a long time. I'm just still trying to get my bearings here. See what all's going on. Cool. Oh man, were you guys around for, if you were around for Ivana's Hangout, have you snagged one of those Little Puff posters yet? It's our baby Crookshanks poster, but they're being signed by Little Puff, Ivana's cat. That's one of my favorite perks. I think that's just the coolest. I really like it. All right, I'm loading more comments. Sarah says she's looking forward to her buttons, and she also got the pizza album. And I gotta tell you guys, this pizza album, I swear I will waffle soon. I just want to take a moment to tell you, there's a perk on the Indiegogo at equalityftw.org. It's called Songs About Pizza. And this album has not been as popular as I thought it would be. I thought it would blow the internet's mind because it's not just a compilation album with songs entirely about pizza. Which, come on, dudes, what more could you want in your life? The people on the album are so cool. We've got a bunch of YouTubers. Wheezy Waiter is on there. Gunnarola. Andrew Songs to Wear Pants To. We've also got two really sick bands, Ghost Mice and Cuckoo Kangaroo are on there. Paul DeGeorge, the executive director of the Harry Potter Alliance, has got a song on there. Justin Finch-Fletchley, which if you know from the Wizard Rock scene, pretty much all of his songs are all about pizza, so we couldn't do without him. We got him on there. Neil Cicerega of the Potter Puppet Pals has a song on there. We also have Margot. I can't pronounce her last name because she's Dutch. But Margot, who was a finalist in Leaky Stars at LeakyCon, she is on there as well. And the one that we can't usually tell you about, because we have an agreement that we're not going to promote them that much, but the Pizza Underground is on this compilation album. If you don't know who the Pizza Underground is, it's Macaulay Culkin's band. Macaulay freaking Culkin's band. They're on our compilation album. I think that's pretty sick. So that is my personal favorite perk, and I think you should all go donate for that. I'll stop talking about perks for now. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just really excited. Like, you saw how excited I got about the cotton candy on the waffle iron? That was like a microcosm concentrated thing about how excited I actually am for this fundraiser. Okay. But I think it is time for the next waffle. Except, all right, here's the deal, though. We're going to go into the next waffle. But while that happens, I want to raise $100 more. So right now we're at $104,836. So while we're doing the next waffle, I want us to get to $104,936. So just 100 more. That's just two of you buying Will It Waffle perks. Or you could buy a Will It Waffle perk and a Lil Bub, not Lil Bub, Lil Puff poster. Or you could buy a lot of buttons. And one thing about the buttons is they're $10. If you donate $10 for anything in this fundraiser, so get a button, get whatever, if you donate at least $10, you're entered to win a pillow that has been like signed and doodled on by Darren Chris. So there's like a million reasons to win, and there's the whole matching thing. Not win, a million reasons to donate. But anyways, yeah, we're at 104,836 right now, so let's get to 936 while I'm doing this next waffle. I think that sounds good. We gotta make this, you know, kind of like a telethon. It's waffles for charity. We're here for waffles, but we're also here for the good of humanity and the world, because waffles will save the world one day. I believe in that. I really do. Okay, so the next waffle was suggested by Anderson, which is not me saying Anderson weird. That's me not pronouncing this person's handle very well. But it is his handle is Anderson, and he is Canadian, or at least a big fan of Canada, because he wants me to waffle a great Canadian breakfast, aka a Tim Hortons donut dunked in Tim Hortons coffee. So that is what we're gonna be waffling. I have here in my microwave, which is my camera stand right now, it's my microwave. I have a Tim Hortons coffee that's probably cold. It was in the microwave because I was trying to keep it warm, but I was walking through a big rainstorm in New York for about a half hour, many, many blocks, so I don't think it's that warm anymore, but it is Tim Hortons coffee. So for those of you who don't know, because I didn't, the proper way to eat this Canadian breakfast is to dunk a Tim Hortons donut into a double-double coffee. Now, I have to admit, I forgot that part when I got this coffee. it's supposed to have two creams and two sugars. That's what double-double means. I forgot to do that, so it's a black coffee. But I have my own cream and sugar we can add, so we'll do that. Let's try this coffee, though. Yep, that is really cold coffee. It's okay. It still tastes good, though. Tim Hortons. All right, let's turn on the next waffle iron while I get this proper Canadian breakfast ready. There are a lot of cords going on over here, guys. It's starting to get really complicated. Also, washing up tonight is going to be a much bigger challenge than it usually is. All right. Ooh. This waffle iron has a dial. Crazy. All right, let me grab these donuts. So I figured, like, you know, you probably want to get a cake donut, seems like the thing. I don't know what the proper donut for a Canadian breakfast is, but I assumed it was something like a cake donut, so that's what I went for. Let me just grab some sugar. I feel like you guys are in my kitchen, like you're just seeing me, like, grab things out of my kitchen everywhere. I don't know, it's weird. It's kind of weird having 80 people in my kitchen right now. I guess I have, you know, thousands of people in my kitchen when they watch my videos. That actually does weird me out sometimes. Someone, like, put some picture of me on Tumblr that was, like, a screen share from Will It Waffle, or a screen cap, and, like, I know that I put videos from my kitchen on the internet every week, but for some reason, seeing a picture, I don't know, it just weirded me out, and I was like, my kitchen is on Tumblr. This is weird. I don't know, guys. I'm not very logical. How are we doing on fundraising right now? As I made to raise $100. Well, we raised. Oh, hey, we're up 60 more. Good job, guys. We're halfway there. What have you guys been? What have you been buying? I have these. I have some internal ways I can see what's going on. Oh, some more Will It Waffle buttons. Thank you, Catherine and Aaron, and Catherine with C. The last one was with the K. And Melanie. Dude, I'm gonna have a lot of buttons to send out. Cool, I'm excited, actually. All right, let me get some. It's a vegan double coffee. That's what we're having right now. We've got Tim Hortons coffee. I just added some sugar to it. Now we're gonna add the cream. You know, cream, almond cream. Ew, yeah, let's stick to calling it almond milk. Almond cream sounds gross. All right, give that a stir there. The sugar that I put in is not gonna dissolve because the coffee is so cold. Jeez. Good thing I like iced coffee. I wonder if I should just heat this up. That seems so gross to, like, nuke it. We're just gonna go with it. All right. This waffle iron is heating up, which means I shouldn't touch it on the metal part anymore, because that's stupid of me. Okay. This is getting complicated. Why are there not tripods for laptops, guys? Someone needs to invent that. Or someone, aka Google, should just make it easy to connect DSLRs to Google Hangout. That would be easier than inventing laptop tripods. Whatever, Google. I'm not bitter. Hangout's great. It's a great product. Okay. Can you see that now? Oh, look at this. It's pretty. You can see everything. You know what? I haven't checked in on comments, though. As this continues to see what you guys are saying in case there's anything important, like I left my fly down, which you can't see because I'm wearing an apron, so ha, maybe I don't even have fronts of pants on right now. I just have backs of pants because I'm wearing an apron. You don't know. Oh, my comments are starting to be weird, guys. Sometimes they do that on Hangouts. Mega Minecraft Fan 101 asks if I have a Twitter. I have a Twitter. My Twitter is Lauren the Bird. But there is also a Twitter for the Harry Potter Alliance, which this fundraiser is for, and that is the HP Alliance. People in the know, put those in the comments because then it'll be spelled correctly. Waffles will save the world. Swiggity swag. Waffling's in the bag. What? Sure. Cool. several people have been asking me to announce the winner poster contest from the Ivana Hangout. I don't know about that. Not my department. But if anyone in the HPA wants to figure that out and G-chat me and let me know, I would be happy to announce it. In case any of you are, like, sticking around just for that reason. In which case, actually, I'm not going to tell you, because I'm going to force you to keep watching Will It Waffle. Peter Pan will be at tea with Harry Potter? No way! What? This is in the comments. Macy West said that I'm going to have tea. You guys don't understand. Peter Pan's my hero. Oh, you just made me so excited. Oh, man. I'm very excited about that. Someone says that they've been thinking about getting awkward tea with Harry Potter, but they're really scared it's going to conflict with amazing programming. Here's the thing. That is definitely a risk you're going to have to take. However, it's not going to conflict with anything that any Harry Potters are at, and that's clearly going to be the best programming. So
You're set. You're fine. Grace Gordon, who I just met this weekend, she's in our Philadelphia community chapter, says that she's watching this at the box office of a live performance at the Philadelphia Shakespeare Theater. Okay, that's cool because I like Shakespeare, but at the same time, you should be watching the Shakespeare. And also, she says to waffle a pumpkin spice latte. You know what? If someone donates for that, I'd be really into that. I think that would be cool. That would be really cool. Okay. This has been the longest amount of time. How many times have I said, I'm gonna waffle this now, and I haven't? I keep getting really interested in your comments and seeing where we're at. All right, we blew past that goal. What even happened? That was such a low goal. We weren't moving for a while, so I was like, let me set a modest goal. We're at 105,446. What, did someone even buy something for $1,000? What just happened here? Oh yeah. I don't know this person's name because their name and their email, but someone got a Wizard Activist starter kit, which is legit. I didn't realize how popular these buttons were gonna be. Thanks, guys. Lucas and Ashley, thank you for getting some buttons. Someone also got Maureen's fanfic. That's tied with songs about pizza for being my favorite perk. Okay, we blew past that goal. She still don't. I don't math, guys. How? I don't understand math. But let's set a new goal so that we can keep things moving along. And also, I should like set some sort of incentive. Like I know I'm waffling things. These waffles were preordained, however. So leave in the comments what you think an incentive could be that's not waffling something specific. Because if I'm gonna waffle something, you'd have to donate explicitly for that in the perk that's up on the Indiegogo site. But in terms of just raising money, like you can donate smaller amounts altogether and we'll get the total number up. So I could do other things that aren't specifically waffling. I'm not sure what those other things are. But if you can think of anything, leave it in the comments and I'll check it out and we'll come up with something that I can do. All right, this man. I keep forgetting the matching donation is on there, so it's like when someone buys buys a button, it's $20, not just $10, because we are really rolling here. This is great. Hold on, hold up, hold up. Thank you, Brittany, for getting Oil the Waffle button. Okay, actually gonna do this. I'm gonna do this now. This waffle iron's gonna be so hot now. Okay. So we've got the Tim Hortons coffee. We've got the donut. Should I like? I know when you eat this, you just dunk a little bit. But since we're putting it on the waffle iron, I feel like we should put like just dunk the entire thing in. I did also get a set. Oh wow! Ow! A cooking spray like hadn't dissolved yet, and I put my face down in the waffle iron like you do, and it kind of got in my eyes. All right, well, my eyes are not gonna stick to the waffle iron now if I decide to waffle my eyeballs, which would be cool if they weren't my eyeballs. If anyone has connections to like a mortician's or something, and you've got some fresh eyeballs you could send to me, like fresh though, I want them juicy, I would waffle those. Boy, I better never run for office or anything, huh? Because some weird stuff they would pull out on me. All right, let's dunk this waffle now. And by waffle, I mean donut. How do I? Okay, we're just gonna dunk the whole thing. Really saturate this in this double coffee, even though this is not how you eat it. Maybe it is how they eat it in Canada. I'm learning all about Canadian culture from this waffle from Anderson, and I'm very sorry for pronouncing your handle wrong. I don't know how I should pronounce it. All right, Canadian breakfast from Tim Hortons. This is much different than the cotton candy. This one's going to be a little bit slower. It's not even really sizzling. It's vaguely unexciting right now. Leave in the comments what you think is going to happen, though. My general opinion is I think, well, it's actually kind of interesting. If we were just doing a dry donut, then I would think that we'll get some cool waffle patterns. It'll be a little heated again. A straight up dry donut, though, I think might be a little stale. afterwards. Like, when you get the double cooking on the iron, sometimes things that are already baked just sort of, they taste too baked, you know? Taste a little stale. But because we saturated this with the double coffee, let me just, like, advertise for Tim Hortons here. Why the hell not? Maybe they'll offer me a sponsorship. Maybe they'll donate to Equality for the Win. There we go. Beautiful. Since we saturated it in the coffee, maybe it'll come out, like, kind of perfect, you know? Because then it won't be as dry. I'm not a scientist, guys. I almost feel like, okay, I know the waffle iron's on because it's hot, but, like, you know, not much is happening. Have some coffee. All my stickers falling off. Have you guys seen? This is the Harry Potter Alliance official apron here. It's not, it was never a Starbucks apron. That's for darn sure. And this is starting to sizzle a little bit. I don't know if you can hear that. Sizzling a little bit. I think maybe it finally broke down to some point where it's really cooking now. Before it wasn't doing too much. I do have it on a pretty low setting. So Tim Hortons, I'm just going to get down here. Hey guys, how's it going? Tim Hortons is associated with Canada. I don't know if it was founded there or if it's just really common there or they just really like it, kind of like the French horn, you know, it's not from France, but French people like it, so it's the French horn. I only went there for the first time while I was in Detroit, Michigan for the Harry Potter Alliance's Apparating Library event. I went there with our University of Michigan's before we ran the Apparating Library event where we were able to give away, I think we gave away a couple thousand books to families in the Brightmoor neighborhood of Detroit, which is one of the most challenged neighborhoods in the entire Midwest. And it was such a beautiful day. We got to give away a bunch of books and all the families were really happy about it. But what was great, we had actually had 50,000 books donated to the Brightmoor Community Center. So that was something that HPA members and chapter members from all around the world sent books to Brightmoor to give away to this neighborhood, to the communities, to the families at this event. That's one of the many amazing things that the Harry Potter Alliance does, one of the many things that they've done just in the past year. And that's part of their Accio Books book drive. Actually, I just realized I'm wearing an Apparating Librarian shirt right now. Look, that's from the, you can't really see it, but that's from the event, Apparating Librarian. Anyways, Accio Books is the annual book drive of the Harry Potter Alliance, and over the years they've been doing it, our members and chapters have collected and donated over 200,000 books, and we built a library in Brooklyn one year for a school that didn't have one. It's the Imagine Better Library. So, done a lot of amazing things there, and this fundraiser that this Will It Waffle is raising money for funds projects like that. It provides resources to our chapters around the world so that they can keep doing projects like that. So you should totally donate, as you guys have been. You guys are rocking tonight. What? We're at 105,836. And also, I forgot that this is on a waffle iron, and we should see what happened. Forgot that it was cooking, so it might be a little overcooked now. Oh, it smells good, though. That happens with a waffle iron sometimes, is it really brings out these smells. Like, you can smell the sugars really came out here. I'm gonna get this coffee away from my laptop, though. Okay, you guys ready? Ooh, pretty. It is definitely, looks pretty much like I thought it would. Very pleased with. I'm very excited about that. Looks great. Is it hot? Oh, it's a little hot. Oh, you know what? Wait, okay, this feels familiar. I mean, the first thing I was gonna say, it's hot. The first thing I was going to say is that it feels like if you were making a donut homemade and it's not quite done yet, it feels like something else. When I picked it up, it triggered something in my memory. Funnel cake. It feels like funnel cake. Oh, man. Should I put powdered sugar on it while I eat it? I have lots of powdered sugar. This can happen. I'm going to do this. That's my cupboard. Hold on. All right. We're just going to... I'm gonna make a funnel cake out of this donut. Is that not what I'm supposed to do? And descend. I'm supposed to be following the like proper Canadian breakfast, but this is too exciting. I'm gonna do it.
Let's get a plate for this donut. Oh, oops. Okay. Donut. Because of the coffee and the waffling, it now feels like funnel cake. So we're gonna turn it into a freaking funnel cake. This is the magic of waffle irons. Dude, this waffle iron just turned a donut into a funnel cake. It had nothing to do with the coffee. Just all the waffling and the magic of equality in this fundraiser. All right. Ooh. Yeah. Oh, guys. I just laughed on the powdered sugar and sprayed the powdered sugar all over my key. Okay, fine. I'm hopeless at being a human being. All right. Let's eat this. Oh, man. I could use more sugar, actually. That's so good. I wish I could give this to you guys. It was just like, I think I was, for once in my life, I was actually right about the fact that, hold on. You know how I said if I just like normal cooked it, like dry donut, it would probably be pretty stale, but putting the coffee on it would give it a great texture and consistency? That's what happened. All right. I'm cleaning my hand. Oh, that's why I'm wearing an apron. Great. Good forethought, Past Lauren. Things get messy in Will It Waffle. I make a mess of our kitchen so much. I don't know how my roommate puts up with me. All right, let's check some comments. Well, I enjoy this amazing funnel cake donut, courtesy of Anderson. Oh, man. This is good stuff. Poke holes in the donut with a fork, then pour the coffee over it just so it was really soaked with the coffee. Yeah. Donating for a new vid idea, you create a vid and leave the person's account. Also, they get to choose what you waffle. I don't quite understand that one. I think I kind of get it. Waffle eggs with the shell. Alyssa, I don't, but what, it would crash, like, and then you would just have, you couldn't eat that. There would be shell everywhere in the egg. I mean, that would be really fun. I have some extra eggs that I'm not gonna use, that I had to buy for something else. I'm not gonna use the rest of them because I'm going down to town tomorrow. So we could just crunch eggs in a waffle iron, right? I'm okay with that. We could incentivize that, maybe, because that's not really waffling it. That's just an excuse to crush eggs. Comments are hard. They just don't load really well. Hey, I just got an email, and Anderson is pretty much the right way to pronounce that. So, magic of waffle. Can you waffle peanut butter and jelly sandwiches if you donate? Sure. Buttons are sold out. What, my buttons are sold out? Did we put a cap on that? That's probably smart because I can't afford too much shipping. That's the whole reason that I don't usually offer these buttons. But did they really sell out? Wow. Thanks, guys. Glad I had that idea last minute. Oh, man. Glynis is asking if I will take suggestions from the comments. Here's your answer, Glynis. If you want to suggest something for me to waffle right now tonight, then you have to donate to the fundraiser, which is, hold on, I can't see that. EqualityFTW.org. It is a fundraiser tonight. It's a fundraiser for equality initiatives for a nonprofit organization called the Harry Potter Alliance. You can donate if you go to equalityftw.org and scroll down. There's a Will It Waffle perk, and you can donate. And if I have it in my house, I will waffle it on air tonight. However, I am also taking suggestions for incentivizing things tonight. I haven't come up with anything to incentivize. What's up? Maybe crushing eggs. I kind of just want to like throw the eggs against my wall. I'm not going to do that, though. If I'm in a really destructive mood, I kind of want to like... hold on. I've got some magical people working behind the scenes. I'm gonna just ask them some things. Ooh, that makes me really thirsty. Good thing I had to get this coffee too. Let me see the, let me just check the last, the people who bought buttons, since it apparently sold out. I just want to thank Brittany and Julianne. Oh, and that was the last two. I think I thanked everyone else for the waffle buttons. And thank you for donating for other things. I see a couple of Wizard Activist starter kits, some Hank Green zines. Those are all really cool perks. I kind of can't believe some of the perks that we've gotten this year. Let's see. Apparently everyone is having trouble with the comments on the stream. I can also, this worked really well during the StarKid hangout, was using the hashtag instead. So if you guys want to use EqualityFTW as a hashtag, if comments aren't really working for you, I'll also keep an eye on that. Looks like a couple of people already are, so that's pretty cool. I've got some people are tweeting me too. oh, cool. Laptop tripod. If only I owned that right now. Apron should become actual HP Alliance merch. I know, but like, I mean, I agree. I think I look pretty fly right now, guys. I mean, check this out. But like, why would we sell aprons? And how many people, I know you guys would buy them, but like, how many people would actually buy them? I should make Will It Waffle aprons, though. I want Will It Waffle branded waffle irons. That's what I want the money to do someday. Should I apply for a grant for that? You, some like philanthropist would fund that. I'm like, yeah, I need some waffle irons with some smiling waffles engraved into them. Yeah, I need that. All right. How are we doing with the fundraiser? We've got one more waffle for sure that's happening. One more person who has donated tonight. I just refreshed and the amount didn't go up at all. That's really sad. I'm just kind of checking in on your comments to see. You get ideas from your donors and the YouTube channel in description of that vid. Let's see. Quality FT waffle is a thing. That is a thing. I was trying to make a thing, but I figured a quality FTW would be an easier hashtag. I mean, I could use either hashtag. I'll check both. good waffle puns happening in there. Thanks, guys. Let me just add Equality FTW waffle to my tweet deck so that I can track this. Cool. All right, couple of incentive ideas. Wait, you should have a booth at GeekyCon where people can bring things for you to waffle in exchange for a donation to the HPA. Could also be the secret Golden Snitch Witch's booth. I like that. it can't happen because I'm too busy at GeekyCon. Someone else could man the booth, maybe. I'm just hoping I can do another live Will It Waffle because I have something I would really like to do for that. We have that already planned out of something was set in stone last year that we're going to do. But anyway, I really like that idea. I also like that it would be the secret cover for the Snitch Witches. I do have, coincidentally, I have the ingredients to make Snitch Witches. So if any of you are thinking about donating for a waffle tonight, I could waffle Snitch Witches. I've already done it on an episode, but I could do it again. Waffle just eggshells. We don't even waffle the egg inside of the shells, just waffle the eggshells. Do something weird with an egg every time we hit a goal. That could maybe happen. Oh, is this still plugged in? No, it's not. Why are you making noises? Silly magical waffle iron. Incentive, how to basic a waffle. I mean, how to basic is this channel.
Do peanut butter face. I might not have enough peanut butter for that, actually. I was gonna buy more peanut butter today, and then hold on. Let's see where we're at with fundraising. If someone bought a wall, hold on. Okay, no, someone bought something else. I thought for a second someone bought a waffle perk, and I was like, no way. I mean, like you should, but I was just gonna be like really excited for a second. That would be really cool if you did. Oh wait, that wouldn't make sense because that math. I'm really bad at math, if you guys didn't know this. Eggs, doing something with eggs if we hit a certain amount. Would people actually be excited about that? I could do that if we get to 106,000. Excuse me. That's another thing that gets cut out of videos. Sometimes I leave it in, but I burp a lot while I'm eating weird things that should not be consumed. Yeah, if we get to 106,000, I'll throw some raw eggs on a waffle iron and we'll just crush them. See what happens. Maybe I'll do other weird things. 106,000. That's what we're gonna do. Bam. You can tweet it, Claudia, the tweeting ghost of Quality for the Win Hangouts. That's what Claudia has become. Ooh, what did I just do to my computer? I don't know what I did. Okay. Let me check these hashtags. Quality FTW, HPA aprons. Okay, cool. Let's go to this third waffle. Currently is the final waffle that's gonna happen unless anyone else donates for a waffle. We've only been on for an hour. Guys, I feel like I've been doing this for so much longer than an hour. This is so hard when it's just you. Oh, I have so much more respect for like all those YouTubers who do you nows like every week. All right, so the last planned waffle might be one more, but the third one that was already bought was by James Cheek. And let me warm this up. All right, and this is actually one of the most suggested waffles in the comments. I actually, before I started season two, I went through and made it almost a database of comments and tweets and Tumblr messages and stuff that I've gotten of people telling me to waffle things because I wanted to find the most recommended thing ever. The most recommended Will It Waffle is mac and cheese. I'm lactose intolerant, so that hasn't happened yet. The second most recommended is grilled cheese. Same thing. That has not happened yet for those reasons. And then after that, the most recommended was bacon. So I did bacon earlier. But this is a really, really highly requested one, and it's requested in a couple of different forms. So if I put them all together, it might even be the most highly requested of all. Hold on. Let me just get to Claudia, the tweeting ghost. All right, so the waffle that I've been building up to is cake batter, like just batter. So it's gonna be like waffle batter, but it's cake batter. So this is gonna look the most like a waffle of anything I've ever waffled, but it's not gonna taste like a waffle. It's gonna be really interesting. And I should probably clean up a bit so that you can see what's going on here. I want to add some water to this. I don't know. Is this liquidy enough? I don't know what the consistency should be of cake batter when it's pretending to be waffle batter. I don't know about that. Yeah, and I'm a little curious. I mean, I think it's going to be like probably a really thick, really sweet waffle. I wonder how much of the cake consistency will be there, seeing as it's not being baked in an oven.
How do you? I'm trying to point at the oven. It doesn't work. You know, it's being baked on a waffle iron, so like, I don't know. It'd be really interesting to see what the texture and consistency is like.
Now I've got to try and.
This waffle iron's not as safe. Just got to clear out some space so that you guys can see what I'm doing here. By the way, I've been listening to Bleachers all day. I want to get batteries stuck in my head, so that's probably what I've been sort of humming. Ooh, I have cotton candy stuck to my microwave. Ugh, my roommate's not going to be happy. What if she comes home in the middle of this? She's out with friends right now. That might happen. The kitchen is a wreck right now. You see, I just scraped that off our microwave. Oh, jeez. Okay, what was I saying? Oh, I was saying that you should listen to Bleachers. They're a good band. That was the point of that. All right, got lots of stuff. How are we doing on our goal? I'm gonna waffle whole eggs if we get to 106,000. Wow, all right, we're at 105,936, so we're like $70 away. I don't do math, that's not my department. We're actually, math and me used to be friends. I still like him, but for some reason, he just doesn't want to hang out with me. Ooh, this is the big waffle iron. Ooh, and it's smoking a lot. Whoa, can you see that? All right. Ooh, look at this shot. You've got the logo in it, and then, like, it's very nice. Hold on. How do you... Yeah, there we go. Well, put my arm down. Ha, okay, sorry. I'm a communications director. I'm all about the branding. Okay, let me check the comments before we put this on there. I just feel so... not connected to you guys. Like, I wish I could just hear you all leaving comments instead of having to, like, interrupt the show to go read them. Excuse me. Oh, Megan's seeing Bleachers in concert on Saturday. I'm jealous. You know what happened with me trying to see Bleachers? So... there's this show that, I saw a band that opened for another show, and we liked that opening band, so my friend messaged me and was like, hey, they're playing, this band that we saw open, they're playing a show, do you want to go see? And I was like, and then it was like a week until the show, and he was like, man, they sold out, I didn't know they were such a big deal, unless this other band they're playing with called Bleachers is, like, people must like them. And I was like, dude, Bleachers is, like, in the top 40 right now. That's why it sold out. And I was also like, had you told me Bleachers was playing, I would have bought that ticket immediately. All right. Make HP aprons a perk for next year. Someone has just emailed me asking if I have popcorn in my apartment. I have an interesting answer to that. Let me respond. All right, you have to listen to my boring anecdotes and then just watch me write emails. It's not very fun. I should have had a waffle assistant tonight. That would have helped things. All of my friends were busy tonight. That's a lie. I just don't have friends. Will it waffle? Okay. Go on YouTube to check. Is that directed at me? I don't... Draw Sharpie faces on... Oh, draw Sharpie faces on the eggs! I like that idea. People will be egg-sided. Blenderize an egg still contained in the shell. Maybe. Oh, someone asks if I still have Jaffa cakes. All right, so for, like, the entire first season of Will It Waffle, there I had a box of Jaffa cakes in a bowl on top of my microwave, so people kept requesting it every episode, and I only kept them for so long because I don't really like them, and I thought I might waffle them, but eventually I was like, it's just not happening, and I just threw them, I don't have them anymore. People are saying they would help run the Will It Waffle booth. maybe I should actually suggest that. But I can't afford a booth, guys. You have to pay for booths at cons. You have to, like, pay for them to have one. And I can't afford that. So that probably won't happen. But that is a good idea. So maybe we'll think of something similar, because that's pretty cool. Maybe there'll be, like, lots of Will It Waffle programming. Sorry, someone just tweeted a picture with me and I don't remember taking it. Oh, this was this weekend. Hi, you were fun. And so, you guys are tweeting awesome stuff. Someone drew a picture of me waffling in this apron right now. That's wild. Thank you, D&O and Steph. You were fun this weekend meeting you. The goal is met. I've just been talking this whole time. I haven't even waffled yet. We met the goal. All right, guys. So now I have to waffle an egg, too. That's awesome. What did I say? I think we'll do it on the blue waffle iron. Waffle iron that is now blue. Ooh, someone bought a Puppets of YouTube calendar. Thank you, Irene. Fun fact, if you don't know, the Puppets of YouTube calendar does not only feature all of the Potter Puppet Pals throughout the 12 months. It also features my wrists in almost every month, so you can see my wrists. That's gonna convince people to buy that calendar. Wow, all right, so we met that goal. So I'm gonna do the eggs after I get my butt in action and do this cake batter, but we should set another incentive. I am emailing with someone who is trying to come up with something that they might want me to waffle. So that could happen. Wait. There's too many like comments and hashtags. Thank you guys though. spaghetti. Okay. Also, can I just show you these eggs really quick? You guys are getting a full-on sense of how distracted I get by things tonight. So I usually buy like brown eggs. I usually really look I like to know where my food comes from and be a responsible consumer. But I only needed one egg for this cake batter, and I was like, freaking, I can't just buy one egg, and I'm going out of town tomorrow. So I bought the smallest package I could of eggs, which is why I have extra eggs. And these are like, these eggs are already stamped with things. Which, you know, it was probably not a bad thing, but it's so industrial to me. It made me feel weird. Okay, you guys ready for cake batter? I think, oh no, my apron broke. Don't look. Don't look until I have it back on. I am ready. Sorry, so I'm getting a Will It Waffle request potentially, so we might have something else to waffle besides the cake batter and then raw eggs, which was awesome. Was awesome. I haven't done it yet. Guys, I'm so false. You can tell how, like, I'm very used to just, like, speaking and being a host and, like, having lines that I know I'm supposed to say. So sometimes things slip out or I just go on, like, what's it called? What's cruise control? Yeah, that's what I do sometimes. But, really like that you can see the blue waffle iron in the background, right there. That one just looks so cool. I'm still excited about that. All right, cake batter, as recommended and donated for by James Cheek, who you can follow on, I believe, most social media as RangerBeef309, I think. Oh, by the way, Hilda from our Dutch and Belgian chapter, she was the one who recommended the, what did I do? Cotton candy. You can follow her on most things as WeasleyTheKing93, I think some of her social media is different than that. But they are both really cool people, so you should follow both of them. If you're in the comments, represent, shout out so people can find you and follow you. And also, James, who recommended this one, I know that he is actually a veteran, so you should definitely shout out to him and thank him for that, because that's something that is beyond my ability to even comprehend of how, like, serious and incredible that is. I could never do something like that. So anyway, cake batter time. I like this waffle iron that it's, like, it's up really high. So look, we can get this, like, it's really nice. It has a tripod. It's a waffle iron tripod. Except it's obviously not a tripod because it doesn't have three legs. But you get the idea. We should definitely spray this. All right, so leave in the comments what you think is going to happen to this cake batter, because that's what you do, is you leave comments about what you think is going to happen. Isn't that kind of cool, though? Like, what if you started doing that with Will It Waffle episodes? Like, pause the video before I start waffling and write what you think is going to happen, and then watch the video, and then say if it happened. It's like, you can make your own hypothesis, and then I'll do the experiment. And then you be like, oh, I was right, oh, I was wrong. And every time you do that, you should make it a bet with the Harry Potter Alliance and donate money if you were wrong. Let's waffle cake batter. Also, what does this say? Also, the Will It Waffle buttons are back on the page. They sold out at 10, so if you were not one of the 10 lucky people who got a Will It Waffle button, they're back on. I will send more out. I showed you how many I have. I have a lot, so let's send more of those out. I think they're really fun. And well, apparently other people do too. I'm gonna waffle cake batter now. Oh, wait, should I fill up the whole thing like you do with a waffle? I mean, what's the worst that'll happen? I'll come out the sides and I have more of a mess to clean up. So let's do it. Oh man. It's gonna be so, like, thick and rich. Oh boy. Oh. Apart from wishing I could talk to you guys and you guys being in the comments, like I was saying, I wish I could just, like, hear you instead of having to check a comment. I also wish you guys could eat this. We did Will It Waffle Live at LeakyCon. Everyone got to eat what I waffled. All right, let's close it. Ready? Ooh, that's squelched. All right, I know this is a fancy waffle iron, so we're gonna turn it. Ooh, wait, it thinks it's done. You're not done. You are not done yet. Doesn't understand. It's cake. He's like, this isn't a waffle. Get this off of me. That's what he was saying. That's how that waffle iron talks. carried away. Oh, that song is so stuck in my head. What are we at? 106,216. What did my friend Alora from the Potter Puppet Pals just bought a John Green signed poster. That's pretty cool. Thanks for donating during Will It Waffle. Oh my god, guys, you're missing this. What? Hold on. Look. What? What? Oh my gosh. Okay, so here's a thing about cake batter. It's for a cake, so there's probably yeast in it, right? Because it has to... it's growing so much. So it has to, like, rise in the oven, right? And it, like, can't rise here, so it's just going crazy. I gotta turn the vent back on. This is smoking. I can't make the firearm go off this late at night. Oh, my gosh. Oh, it smells like cake now, too. Okay, so I really didn't need to put that much on. Oh, it came out a little on that side. Oh. Flop. That was funny. Oh boy. Oh
amused me so much. Oh, I'm getting cotton candy on the bottom of my laptop now. Oh, I'm going to clean my laptop tomorrow.
Oh, smoking a lot. Maybe let's just see if it's, yeah, this is, oh, well, I had to flip it over, so some of the, like, chocolate just went,
it was cool. My lower third is blocking it, so you can't see. All right, you guys ready?
Ready to see what happened? Oh, it looks beautiful. It's a beautiful waffle baby. This is just, it's a little, oh, it looks so great. When I was little, we used to sometimes make chocolate waffles, and they looked like that. I don't know if it'll taste the same. Should I eat it like a waffle? Should I put like butter and syrup on it? Oh, I don't want to eat that much right now. This is, you know, sometimes when you like read behind the scenes interviews about like TV shows or movies and they talk about a scene where they were eating something and you've seen that scene and you're always like, oh my God, that food looks so good. And then the actor's like, oh yeah, I hated having to eat that food. And you're like, what? Let me tell you, Will It Waffle has made me understand that. Because it's a lot of food that I have to eat. And if you see me eat on camera, that's all I eat because it's a lot. You need to like start donating it to something. I don't know. It's wasting food. I feel bad about that. Figure out something for that. But anyway, let's try this. Let's try this one. spoon is stuck to the plate with cotton candy. What happened here tonight? Oh boy. Ooh, okay. It's definitely cakey. Can't lift it up like you might a waffle. Yeah, it's definitely like a cake. Ooh. Yeah, this is very, very delicate. Like it's waffled fine. It's just falling apart when I'm trying to get it off because it is totally like a cake.
It's also very hot. Look at that, guys. Oh, smells like a cake. Looks like a cake. I guess I should put frosting on it instead of on, like, syrup or butter. But frosting. I finally got rid of it. But I do have... That could have been so much more casual. I was about to make that the... Okay, here we go. Yay! It's the 9th birthday cake. Aww. Well, was. There we go. What's a birthday cake now? Yay! Happy 9th birthday, HPA. It was the Harry Potter Alliance's birthday recently. Oh, yeah. Do you guys know what just happened? Do you know what just happened? We just got a donation for another Will It Waffle. Oh, boy. So in addition to the egg that we are going to do because you guys were amazing and got us over $106,000, right? That's $106,000. Thank you, Tren and Jessica, who are on in one of our chapters and on our chapter staff. I'm going to waffle spaghetti. Wait, I have to cook spaghetti. Okay, let's start cooking spaghetti. Hold on. We'll try this cake in a minute. I should start cooking some spaghetti. Also, this spaghetti belongs to my roommates. Remember that secret earlier about not telling her that I used this waffle iron for something that's not waffles? Also, don't tell her I'm using her spaghetti. Oh, she's going to watch this, isn't she? Now, why would she watch this? Okay. Now, where does she keep her spaghetti? Oh, it's almost gone, too. I'm going to have to buy her more spaghetti. This is very rude of me. Where's my pot? All right. So, thank you to everyone who's been donating to Equality for the Win. I'm having a lot of fun tonight. How much, I don't know how much water to boil for spaghetti. I haven't made pasta in, like, years. I used to make it every day, but it's been a while now. All right. Do you put the spaghetti in now or when it boils? I don't know. This is not a cooking show, as I've told you all the time. All right, let's see what this cake tastes like. Look at this plate. This is the most ridiculous plate ever right now. I don't even want a fork.
Let's just tear off a little bit. All right. Waffled cake batter, courtesy of James Cheek. Thank you for donating to Equality FTW. Yeah. Huh, you know, it really tastes like a waffle cake hybrid. Interesting. Don't you guys want some? I really wish I could give this to you. I would really like to be able to share this with someone. I'm feeling really lonely tonight. There's no one here. All my friends are watching Supernatural. That's legitimately what they're doing. They're over at someone's house watching Supernatural because they couldn't watch it together yesterday. Otherwise, they'd probably be here hanging out with me waffling stuff. And all my other friends don't live in New York City because we're internet nerds. And all of our friends live all around the world, as all of you watching know. Know that feel. All right. Let me just check. No one more claimed any buttons. All right, guys, buttons are back up. I'm just checking an email about spaghetti, waffling spaghetti. It's gonna happen. We're boiling water. Maybe the spaghetti's supposed to be in there already. I don't know. I'm not knowledgeable of these things. But anyways, guys, the Will It Waffle buttons are back up. Let me just do another promo for these, in case anyone doesn't know. Right as I say that, Macy buys one. Thank you, Macy. I think because of the lag, that's probably not what happened. You probably didn't hear me, and then was like, I'll buy one. But anyway, Will It Waffle buttons. These are a blue happy. This is orange. It looks more naturally orange in person. It looks very like red or whatever right now. Purple. The purple ones are very rare. I accidentally only made a couple, and you cannot get them in the waffle sad version because I forgot to make them in that version. Also, fun fact, these buttons were made using Neil Cicerega's button maker. You know, if that's cool to you. A lot of them were actually made by his nephew because... it's just worked out that way. That one's green, sad. So we have green, purple, blue, orange, and pink. Like hot pink, like almost magenta. And they come in happy and sad, and I usually sell them when I like go to events and stuff, like conferences. And a lot of people have always asked if I could sell them online because they're not going to the conferences I'm going to. And I usually don't because I gotta pay shipping and stuff, and you know, it would be very expensive. But tonight, for one night only, for charity, for the Harry Potter Alliance, for Equality for the Win, you can buy these and I will send them to you. If you get the perk on equalityftw.org, it is $10 and you get a happy button and a sad button. And I'm gonna email all of you and ask for your color preferences, and hopefully I will have them for you. And yep. So yeah, please get those. Let's set another number goal right now as we whip the spaghetti. And we'll do the egg in just a second. That was our first incentive, was the egg. So right now we're at 106,336. So if we get to 106,5, then let's set a goal for that. I haven't checked in on your comments and stuff for a while. So let's check in here, see if you guys have something else. Just Margaret says I could donate part of my AdSense profit to a food bank to offset wasting the food that I occasionally waste. I like that idea. I think I'll look into that. I actually finally make any money off of AdSense. You have to hit a threshold before they even send you any money, and I have finally hit that. So that is the thing I could actually do. I really like that. Hilda says that the cake was the most waffle-like thing to ever come out of Will It Waffle. It's true. Although I do have to say, when I did an egg, that was a really nice waffle. I really liked that. The one, the egg we're about to do will not be. Megan tells me that spaghetti can go in pre or post boil. Thank you. George C. Alexander says, I need to spend time with Vi Hart, do an episode with her. I did spend time with Vi Hart at VidCon. I don't think she remembers who I am, but I was at a couple of parties with her, and I thought she was really, really cool. Like, I already thought she was cool from her videos. She's even cooler in person and a lot taller than I thought. She's super tall. But she was awesome. The Order of the Phoenix HPA chapter is going to bed. Good night, guys. I know it is late. Props to anyone who's staying up, but I totally understand if you guys have to go to bed. No, Megan brought up a good point about the Will It Waffle booth. Don't let anyone eat the waffles or the convention center will shut you down, because that's what happened at LeakyCon to Snitch Witches. So yeah, good point. There are a lot of things we'll have to consider for this Will It Waffle booth. Okay, wait, next incentive, waffle two raw eggs. I was already gonna do more than one egg, so I think we'll, like, I mean, I don't know what to do with these eggs, except, well, I was gonna give them to my roommate, actually. Equality for the waffle. Thank you to Amanda for screenshotting when I had my weird marketing moment about branding. Thanks for that. All right, so what should we do when we hit the 500, 106,500? All right, well, we already passed that. We're at 106,700. So when we get to 107,000, we'll do something, because we've still got two things to waffle. So we're definitely gonna get there. Thank you to Claire for buying a Will It Waffle button, or buttons. You get two buttons. And also, someone got a Wizard Activist starter kit, Dana, and some Harry Potter prequel things. All right. Is this okay? I think this water's oops, dropping things all over. Okay, so for all the How To Basic fans, because people say that in comments, I've seen some tonight. Okay, so you know how his early videos were just very dry humor actually doing it, and then nowadays it's like wild? Okay, like the middle range videos when they were just kind of hectic but like not as wild as they are now. That's kind of like how my life always is. I'm just like dropping things all over the place all the time, not doing things correctly. Yeah, so anyways, I don't want to eat. There's not too much spaghetti in here. See, what is left is about how much I would want to waffle, but I can't do that much because it's my roommate's spaghetti. Also, it's linguine. In case that's important to you. But this is boiling, so let's put some in. So it's not gonna be too much. There've been so many times I've used my roommate's food for videos. Oh, shit. Oh, I'm so horrible, guys. I owe her a lot. Oh, no. I just got spaghetti everywhere. Oh, and the spoon with the dried up cotton candies on the floor. Oi. I'm a wreck, dudes. I am a wreck. So, while the spaghetti is doing its thing, I think we should do the egg. Let me hook up that waffle iron so we can do that. Ooh. So, like, we'll just crush the eggs, right? We'll put them on the waffle iron and then just, like, crush it down, and that'll be fun. Maybe I'll try to move things out of the splash zone for that. All right, let's check in on how things are going real quick. Ooh, I should plug my laptop in. I haven't said what's going to happen at 107,000. I haven't figured that out yet. I haven't figured out what we should do for that. I think I was trying to get some ideas by looking at the hashtag. Someone says, watching things being waffled is better than homework, while I would agree with that, you might want to consider doing your homework while you watch. I don't want to promote not doing homework. Give me more ideas, again, of things to do as incentives. I know someone said, like, peanut butter face, but I don't quite have enough peanut butter for that. I guess I don't really need any peanut butter before I go downtown. Add marinara. Yeah, see, I would add marinara to the spaghetti before I waffle it, but I don't have any. So, blenderize all the leftover waffles into it. I will do this, actually. This could be an incentive. I will blenderize, like, everything on that plate and, like, the spaghetti. Not the egg, because that'll have shells in it. But I will blenderize everything we waffle and drink at least some of it if we hit a goal. That's pretty gross. So we might want to get to a high goal here, because we got a while to go. So if we hit 107,500, I will blenderize everything we waffle and drink it. How about that? I'm gonna let that sit with you guys while I wait for responses to that. Also, I just wanted to bring up, Witches of Us said, I live in New York City, I could probably just bring all the extra food to a homeless person. That is actually what we used to do when I lived in Manhattan. At NYU, we would have extra swipes in the dining halls, like towards the end of semesters, so we would just get a bunch of like soup or like whatever food and take it to homeless people. And my friends and I still do that when we have like extra food at restaurants. But I don't live in Manhattan. I live outside of the city, and there aren't people nearby. I never see homeless people around here. So that doesn't really work right now. But that is a really good idea. And if you do live anywhere where there are unfortunately homeless people on the street, or if you are eating dinner somewhere, I definitely recommend doing that. It's just like a nice thing that you can do that is no effort for you. It's like you're helping someone out. You're not wasting food that's gonna like somehow hurt the environment because you're like wasting stuff. So it's a really good thing to do. I recommend doing that. I also still like Margaret's idea of donating AdSense to a food bank. I think especially if Will It Waffle like ever gets to the point where I am making like money to cover costs, I think that's a really fitting place to donate money, you know? Like, yeah, I like that idea a lot. I'm loving all of your suggestions for things. You guys are, this is a really, like, maybe I should do more Will It Waffle live shows, because you guys are pretty awesome. Like, you guys all have really good ideas. How many ideas have we come up with tonight? This is crazy. It's also getting really hot in here. I need to check on that spaghetti. my friend Zach says, Lord Bird's really unfamiliar with cotton candy. Yes, I am! Problem. Sorry. All right. Is 107,500 too high? Cause we're like stagnant right now, but I think that's just a thing. Let's say 107,500. I will blenderize, and I'm telling our Claudia the tweeting ghost, everything I waffled tonight and drink it. My landlord might not be happy about that because that's gonna be loud, but we're gonna do it. We're gonna do it for charity. From decreasing world suck, making the world better. Witches of Us lives around the corner from NYU and does the same thing with their leftover swipes that we do. Yep. Yeah, someone says I should be swirling the spaghetti. Good idea. Utensils. I need utensils. Okay. I learned on Honey Boo Boo that the way to tell if spaghetti is done is throw it at the wall, and if it sticks, it's done. But spaghetti's hot, so I don't understand how you would do that, you know? I love Honey Boo Boo. Claudia, the tweeting ghost, when I told her about the blenderizing thing, says, OMG, Lauren, no. But yes, definitely yes. I will tweet it. let's see. Oh, gotta get that out of my head. Wait, you know what'll get it out of my head? We haven't. I meant to do this like every time I waffled something. So let me just do it now. As we. I need to waffle this egg too. Okay, but let's just have a quick jam session. Quick rock out to the best song in the world. Didn't actually mean to turn that on at the like right point, but that was cool. I forgot I've had this waffle iron on this whole time that I've just been talking. But spaghetti's almost done, so let me deal with the spaghetti, and then we'll do the egg here. So let me unplug that really quick. Get out the colander. I'm gonna get the spaghetti ready. Spaghetti ready. All right. Not much spaghetti. I didn't want to steal too much. Ah, that gets hot. Put my glasses. Can you even see? You can't even see my glasses are all steamed up, so I thought it would be funny. But my hair is so long right now, you can't even see my glasses anymore. All right. Just want to do that pretty soon. Let me plug this back in. We'll do the eggs, and then we'll do the spaghetti, which has been donated by Scorpius Malfoy and Jessica Barker of our London Leviosa chapter, which is an amazing chapter. Scorpius Malfoy is from our Pig Farts chapter, I believe. He's been very active in Equality for the Win this year. Let me just check how we're doing on everything. How long will the live show? We've got two more things at least to waffle. We've got to blenderize something, and the blenderizing is only going to happen if we get to $107,500, which we are $570 away from. Math. So, maybe we'll go to like 11. That's Eastern time ish. I'm in this. Wait, I got another Will It Waffle perk? All right, we gotta waffle something else. Awesome. That's so cool. That's sick. I'm gonna email you right now. And so you can let me know what you want me to waffle. And also, I'm going to CC Claudia the Tweeting Ghost so she can help me in case I miss this email. Thank you so much for donating for that. That's so cool. I might have missed your comment. I'm not sure. If you're the one telling me to waffle a hot dog, we're gonna steal even more food from my roommate. Awesome. All right, so we are just over $500 away from our goal of hitting 107,500. Someone say we're almost at our goal? No way. No way. Are we? That's awesome. But I'm behind on things. All right, are you guys ready to do this egg? Because also, here's what happened. I was really excited to do the egg on the cotton candy waffle iron because I wanted to see all the blue. But I've had this on warming up for so long that it's starting to melt off. Actually, it's gonna be even harder to clean. So that'll be fun tomorrow or tonight or whenever I do it. If we hit our goal for the blenderizing, heroes in a half shell. These are whole shells. What if there's. Wouldn't that be weird? Like, why did we start eating chicken eggs? What if we ate eggs of other animals? Do turtles hatch out of shells? I mean, they're reptiles. I know they have, like... This is why this is not a science show, guys. But, you know, turtles aside, what if we had started eating eggs from other animals? All right, let's stop with the egg thing. And, I want you guys to be able to see this, but I also want to splatter this a lot because I want that to be fun. All right, we're going to do 3 eggs in here. This is because you guys got us to a goal I can't even remember because you're doing so amazing tonight and spreading the word and donating, and you got us to... We've raised a lot of money tonight, and it's awesome. So this is why we're doing this. This is in the name of the Harry Potter Alliance's Equality for the Win fundraiser. Look, this is just, like, coming off. This is what cotton candy is now. You ever imagine you would see cotton candy like this? Probably doesn't look as weird to you on camera. All right. You guys ready? I'm excited about this. I feel like we need some epic music. I don't know what to do about that. You guys just all like think of like the final countdown or something really cool in your heads over there, like epic music, and then have that playing in your head while I waffle this. All right, let's go. Okay, you ready? This is gonna get everywhere. I want to do it really hard. Wait, it's probably just gonna like fall down at me. I stop overthinking. I just gotta do it. Whoa. It, like, didn't go anywhere. Went over here a little bit. Oh, no. It went all over my pants. Okay. All right. That's... Whoa. Yeah, that's all over my pants. I think I'm going to be finding egg for a while after this. So you can't see too much happening. Oh, wait. Hold on. Oh, ow! That was hot. There is some yolk sneaking out of the back. Yeah, there you go. You can see that now. See that? It's dripping out over there. Hold on. Got to put the vent back on. Smoking quite a bit. Yep, definitely coming out over the sides there. Dripping, dripping, dripping. Lots of yolk. And it's kind of baking out over here. Huh. Baking out. Oh, I'm so glad that I was off screen for that, because I just did one of those really stupid wink finger gun things, and you guys didn't see it. But then I told you about it. Have you guys all seen my episode where I waffled eggs? I waffled all of breakfast, actually. I put some toast and some sausage on there, too. That was actually one of my favorites because it turned out super tasty and it was just, like, really fast breakfast. It was great. I'm not going to eat this one because there's going to be shells all over it. But I got to tell you, eggs on a waffle iron are actually really good. All right. You guys want to see? Want to see what this is like? I think we can go ahead and open it. Oh, it's like tie-dye. I don't know how much you can see because it's like steamy, but the cotton candy is all in there. You can see right there is some shells. That's some shellage happening. It's still like gurgling over here, the cotton candy. Guys, I have to Instagram this. I want to remember this one, and this eyesight hangout is not recording it like as well as I would want to remember it. This is just wild. It's absolutely wild. I think I'm going to text this to Claudia, the tweeting ghost, really quick so she can have a really clean thing to post on social here. This just looks so cool, dude. Man, there's just like, it's like a swamp. There's these green bubbles coming out because the blue cotton candy mixed with the yolk. So, so wild. Also, she might get this before this happens on her stream. So she's just going to be like, what the F are you texting me? What happens a minute and a half in the future? the lag is probably longer than that, actually. All right, let's unplug this. Very carefully. Ooh, there's just slime on the bottom of this. Very carefully going to relocate you. Here, so we can grab the spaghetti. And let's check in. Oop, that was. There's not another logo under this HPA sticker. Not at all. This is just an HPA apron.
Hold on. Just, I've got a yoke on my hand. I'm trying to type. Okay. Got another nation for you haven't heard of them yet. Let me know in the comments if you are the person who bought a Will It Waffle perk. I emailed you. It might not be an email that you use, maybe, or something. So maybe let me know in the comments if that was you. Maybe say what your email is so I can, you know, be sure and believe that it's you. Not that I don't trust you guys, but it's the internet. Sometimes there's weirdos on the internet. But yeah, I want to know what you want me to waffle. So, and as I'm saying all of this, so thank you, Maddie. Maddie says that she forgot every idea she had, but she's asking if I had candy corn, and I don't. I'm sorry, but I do have cereal. I have two kinds of cereal. I have Golden Grahams and Kix. So we could do either of these. Maybe you can either let me know or the comments can let me know. We gotta do the spaghetti first, so there's time. It's time to decide which will go on the waffle iron. I can say we have, I'm losing what my hands are. We've kind of already waffled Golden Grahams. They were inside of a sandwich and they did not waffle so well. However, on their own, they might waffle. You know, they were in a Snitchwich, so they were with peanut butter and bread, so maybe they would waffle. Kix, they're circular, so they'll probably go into the irons a little bit, so, you know, don't know what'll happen there. I will say, I don't want to, I'm having trouble finishing these more than I am these, so if I wanted to get rid of some, I would vote for these. But, whichever. And also, if we hit our goal, whichever one I waffle for you, I have to put it in a blender and eat with everything else. So as everyone's making the decisions on which one I should waffle, keep that in mind. All right, so we're gonna be waffling cereal after the spaghetti. Guys, when did this become my life? No, okay, Claudia just left a comment about me blendering and saying that I'm drinking the eggshells. Let me just clarify. I'm not going to do the thing I just waffled with the eggshells. I'm not putting in the blender because I'm not going to eat eggshells. I will blenderize everything else we waffled tonight except the egg because that wasn't even an official perk. That was an incentive anyway. So let's see how close we are to our goal. My thing is not refreshing right now. Or we're still over $500 away. One of the two. Wait, is this still live? Am I still alive and working? Because I just saw someone on Twitter say that they're rewatching the Will It Waffle live stream. The Will It Waffle live stream hasn't ended, so I'm just checking things on Twitter. All right. Oh, we're not even at 107,000 yet. We got to get to 107,500 for me to blenderize this. 107,500. So buy a lot of buttons. and remember, so that's, you know, we're about $500 away, but we're actually only like $250 away because every donation is being matched by the Order of the Phoenix, which is a collection of really, really nice philanthropists who support the HPA's work and believe in us and want to support us. If you go to the Indiegogo page and you look just beneath the our total, it says matched funds by John Green and Order of the Phoenix. You can click on Order of the Phoenix and you can actually see the names of all of the nice people there. We've got one of the head curators of Upworthy there. We also have Craig of Craigslist is actually one of the people matching your donation. Everyone else on there have been financially, in terms of ideas and moral support, and they're all really, really great people. They're very nice to be matching donations right now. So
we need to get to $107,500 for me to blenderize everything that I have waffled tonight and drink it. Because that is how you raise money for equality. But it's actually not going to be too hard to get there because we only have to do half of that. The Order of the Phoenix will do the other half. Things that you can get are these Will It Waffle buttons. You can get some of these. Only time you can ever get them online is tonight. So if you have any inclination of liking them, you should get it because tonight's the night. Also, lots of other things on there. You can have tea with Harry Potter and Harry Potter and Harry Potter and Harry Potter and Harry Potter at GeekyCon next year. We also have a bunch of signs. We've got signed posters by John Green. We've got posters signed by Starkid. Posters signed by Ivana Lynch. Posters signed by Hank Green and all of the band members who are on tour with him this summer, which is Harry and the Potters, Driftless Pony Club, Andrew Huang, Rob Scallon. And all of those signed posters I just mentioned are all different posters. So make sure you go to equalityftw.org and check out all of those. Besides posters, we've got an album about pizza. We have a contest to win a signed J.K. Rowling book. It's only $20, and you're entered in the contest. So these books are valued at, like, thousands of dollars, but you could get it for $20. And it's not just a signed book that we, like, happen to have. J.K. Rowling specifically donated it to the Harry Potter Alliance, so that's pretty freaking awesome. Also, if you donate more than anything, so you could get buttons, you could get anything more expensive than buttons, you're automatically entered to win a pillow signed and doodled on by Darren Criss, which is pretty cool. So that was a lot of plugs for that, but we want to get to this goal so that I can drink some blenderized waffle stuff, so I wanted to make sure I went over all of that for you. But now, I think it is time to waffle some spaghetti after I check in with your conversations, because... Oh, thank you for saying we're still live. Okay, Golden Grams, Kicks, Murdering Grams. Oh, so, So Maddie says that Maddie is the one who donated, and she says that we should do Kicks because Graham is her last name, and she feels like she would be murdering Grams if we did Grams. I'm totally cool with that logic. So after spaghetti, we will be waffling Kicks because Maddie donated, and she is awesome for donating. All right, so while I waffle the spaghetti, make sure you're donating or spreading the word. You know, if you've already donated, you can't donate more, you can't donate for whatever reason, that is totally cool. But what you can do to help out, if you want to help out, you want to see me drink blenderized waffled things that are not waffles, you can spread the word. Tweet about it, Facebook, call your friends, tell your friends, Facebook them, kick them. Is that what people say for kick? I still don't understand what kick is. It's the thing the kids are on. Do you say like, go kick this person? Can you verb it that way? That's interesting. All right, let's waffle spaghetti. Which one should we do it on? This one is sitting here. We'll do it on the cake waffle iron. So we'll let him warm up for a minute. Man, I was going to edit a video tonight, but I'm going to have so much to clean up after this. I don't think I'm going to be able to stay awake to edit a video. I've got a meeting very early in the morning tomorrow, so, Like, I know that sounds very random to you guys that I'm saying that, but if you could see the state of my counter right now, you would understand why I'm saying this. It's just okay. As we wait for this to warm up, which I should have done while I was, like, telling you about stuff, I'll just say again, you know, please go tell your friends that this live stream is happening or that the fundraiser is happening. I'm just looking at your perks now. Hilda says maybe the spaghetti will have the crimped hair effect that she was hoping. Yeah, that's why I'm glad that we're waffling spaghetti. Hilda gave me a short list of things. Things better. We waffled the cake and Nettie. Oh my gosh, my friend Rosemary from Study Abroad in Amsterdam in 2010 is watching. What? Rosemary? Did I invite you on Facebook accidentally? How do you even know about this? It's so weird. Do you remember when we used to make pasta every day in Amsterdam? That was like, that's the last time I made pasta. Also, I think you taught me how to break spaghetti. Oh, full circle. It's a full circle right now. Person who taught me how to make spaghetti. I mean, it was probably Rose who taught me how to make spaghetti, but I know you were there a couple of times. guys, this is awesome. This is so cool. Also, so many people with like Dutch connections are watching tonight. Oh, it's so cool. that's really exciting. Hi, Rosemary. That's so cool. We should catch up sometime soon. Instead of me talking to you like this, which is really weird.
This is hot enough yet?
Sorry, I've been doing this like product placement for Surge all night. Should have put a Harry Potter Alliance sticker on that too. Look at this spaghetti. Mwah. Can't wait to eat this blenderized if we get to 107,500. Waffled and then blenderized. You know, when I waffled the thing with, waffled the Happy Meal with John Green, which we did because he blenderized a Happy Meal a long time ago, a lot of people said, oh, I thought you were going to blenderize it and then waffle it, so it'd be kind of like batter. Now we're doing this backwards. We're waffling and then blenderizing. Also, we just passed 107,000, which is awesome. Thank you, everyone, for donating or who's been telling people to come donate. This really, really means a lot to the Harry Potter Alliance. You're making a huge difference for us to be able to continue being an organization. Our budget is somewhere like 80 or 90% member funded from like member-based organizations like Project for Awesome and LeakyCon and this fundraiser from you guys. So this is how we're able to exist and continue. So thank you so much. And let's get to that 500. Like I said, it's really only like 250. Wow, all right, we just jumped to 226. I think we're gonna hit this blenderized goal pretty quick, and we got a couple more things to waffle, so I'm gonna shut up so that we can waffle spaghetti. All right. Got spaghetti, got waffle iron. Ooh, my hand is all slimy from the spaghetti. All right, so spaghetti. Need a fork here. This is sizzling like crazy. How do I turn this? So that's very sizzly. It's very loud. I'm as the night wears on, I'm becoming more and more aware of the fact that my landlord can probably hear everything below me. If there had been more spaghetti on there, I might have left it on longer, but you know, it barely like covered the iron and is pretty thin, so I might not leave it on too long because I don't want it to get too hard, you know? Let me know in the comments what you think is going to happen, by the way. I haven't given too much thought to this one. I know Hilda was hoping it would have like a hair crimping effect, so we'll see if that might happen with the waffle irons. I am using one of the waffle irons with the bigger like squares of the irons, one of the Belgian style ones, because the iron with the small square, a tie-dye egg right now, tie-dye omelet. But yeah, so I think if it was the smaller squares, we might have had more luck getting like a crimping effect. So I'm not positive what will happen here, like just harden. I don't think it'll totally dry up because, yeah, I don't know, I just think it won't. But maybe let's see. Do you want to try? Should we try opening it right now? Just try and move it closer to the camera. Oh, wow. I forgot there was cake batter all over this. There's some looking marks of chocolate brown batter all over my counter now. Oops. All right. Huh. Okay. Probably doesn't look like it did anything to you. It did do a little bit, though. I don't know how I could show this to you, like, because it's just the exposure is really bad on here. Oh, oops. There are kind of like fried hardened bits anywhere the irons came together on top, and it's crunchy in some parts. Let me try and get it off onto a plate so we can really see what happened here. All right, might as well put it on my plate of everything that's going into the blender, huh? Ooh! Who doesn't want spaghetti on their cake waffle? Oh wait, I'm not gonna eat this candle, so I'm just gonna take this off the plate so that I don't accidentally blenderize it. So getting spaghetti off of a waffle iron is more difficult than I anticipated. I guess they haven't invented a utensil for that yet. Hold on. The noise is annoying me, so I want to get all the spaghetti off so it'll stop making this noise. Let's see. Oh, finally, it's getting quieter. I'm like an old person. Like, these loud noises are bothering me. Oh, see, this one, you can tell it's pretty fried. Let's just try this one. Ow. I burned my tongue and my lips. Look, like a walrus. You hear that crunch? I'm very crunchy. I'm crunchy noodles now. But they're not crunchy like they were in the box. It's crunchy like, you know, some Asian cuisine has like crunchy noodles? That's like what it is. So it's actually pretty tasty. You little thing were making all that noise. You tiny little noodle. Wow. This is actually kind of cool. Oh, hold on. Blah. Okay. This is actually pretty cool that it's like, so they don't quite have any sort of shape that they have stayed in. So it didn't crimp, unfortunately, Hilda. But they are kind of crunchy. This was donated by Scorpius and Jessica. Forgot, I was thinking it was donated by Maddie. So thank you for donating for this spaghetti waffle. That was really cool. I really like that. Yeah, like, I recommend this. I mean, there's probably a way you could do it that's not on the waffle iron. But yeah, crunchy noodles. I'm into this. This is the first thing tonight that, the funnel cake donut was really good, but I like want to keep eating this. Really tasty. I'm gonna text my roommate really quickly, because I'm starting to get so paranoid that, like, any noise is her coming home, because she might be spending the night with a friend tonight, and I don't know. Are you coming home tonight? I'm just, like, she knows that I do weird things on the internet, and that I'm always doing weird things in our apartment, but I don't like to necessarily be caught off guard sometimes. Like, one time... I think this has happened multiple times. She's come home, and this is before my hair was, like, long and covering my forehead. But we'd be hanging out, like, all night, like, made dinner together, watched a movie, and then I'd get ready for bed and see that I had a scar on my forehead. And I was like, Allison, was that there this whole time? You haven't mentioned it? And she was just like, well, yeah, you know, sometimes you draw on yourself and you do weird things, so I didn't really question it. Oh, I'm that weird. I'm that weird that when something like that happened, she didn't even blink an eye. All right, we are at 107,326, which is an astonishing amount. It's really, really cool. Oh, Lev Grossman just donated to promote the fundraiser. Lev Grossman, as I'm sure all of you know him, he was, I can't even believe what he contributed to the fundraiser. He's given us a deleted chapter from The Magician's Land, which is the final book in the Magician's trilogy, just came out like over the summer, and he donated a deleted chapter from it. Like, that's insane. Not insane, but I try not to say those words, I'm sorry. But yeah, that was so, so generous of him. If you haven't snagged that yet, if you're a Magician's fan, you absolutely need to, because I'm sure it won't ever be available in any other time, because he just, you know, contributed it for this. That's so cool. So we are $144 away from me blenderizing this plate of stuff. What was the first thing I waffled? Oh, the cotton candy. Ha! Nothing left to blenderize of that. Can't eat that. Ha, ha, ha. I really don't like cotton candy. I think it's cool. And obviously it was the coolest waffle, but I do not care for cotton candy. I just realized my milk has been sitting out on the table. Put that in the fridge. All right, so we need to waffle some cereal now. Trying to decide what waffle iron to use. This logo is not sticking on my apron very well. If we do make HPA aprons, we will make them properly. And they will probably not be green aprons. It looks like you work at a coffee company. What if there were HPA coffee houses? No, that's a bad idea. let me just check in on what people have been buying to get us to this point. Any more buttons have been bought? Might want some thank yous. Someone bought Awkward Tea Time with Harry. All right. Potters. So a lot of Harry Potters are going to be there. Thank you for buying that. Let's see how many of those we have sold. I know we sold out of them before. So, okay, that was the first one tonight. Cool. Oh, and Will It Waffle perk sold out, which is probably okay because it's getting pretty late and we still have to blend our eyes after this last waffle. So, unfortunately, you cannot buy another thing for me to waffle tonight, but you can always recommend things for me to waffle. And like I said, I make a sort of almost a database. I really do pay attention to what you guys are suggesting and try to do the most highly suggested things. And I try to find fun people to collab with, too. So, like, if you're recommending I do something and there's someone who's kind of, for whatever reason, associated with that food, then I like to try to have them on. Someone who's watching, Librarianish Lee, won the signed J.K. Rowling book last year in our fundraiser last year. And she says it was amazing and everyone should donate now. That's so cool. I'm so glad you're watching. That's awesome. Okay, cool. I'm just going to check. Like I said, I hate that I have to kind of pause and slow down to read all of your comments, but I don't want to not look at them. I want to see what you're all saying so I can talk to you and do what you want me to do. Waffle. Oh, wait. Is spaghetti a how-to-basic thing? Hot dogs and eggs are definitely a how-to-basic thing. Spaghetti as well? I don't really remember. I'm still freaking out over the fact that my friend Rosemary from Study Abroad is here. We literally, like, haven't talked since 2010. That's so weird. You know, you guys know what happened? We're getting into the story time of night. It's been story time the whole time. This one thing happened recently. Ashley Mardell, who is amazing. She's a YouTuber. You might know her. She just hit 100,000 subscribers, so she's got a big base. She's really, really cool. She actually, like, apparently mentioned me on a live show a while back, and she kind of, like, told all of her Twitter followers to, like, go tweet me and stuff because we didn't know each other before then, and she was like, I want to be friends with the Will Waffle person, so let's everyone go tweet so that Lauren knows who I am. Anyways, that same night, I had this, like, high school friend who I haven't talked to since high school, was watching that and found out about my YouTube stuff through this other YouTuber mentioning me on their live show. Because I don't really mention that I do YouTube to old high school friends or anyone on Facebook. So that was really weird and really cool, but it was, like, a really weird way for someone to find my secret internet life. I mean, I guess it's not that hard to find. Oh, someone bought a Puppets of YouTube calendar. What's up? And what is it? Okay, let me just double check our total. Because then we don't have too far to go, and we only have to do half of that. All right, 107,426. You know what, guys? You're making me look so impressive tonight. It looks like we're raising so much money because of the match. It has nothing to do with me. It's totally just because everything's being matched. Like, we've only raised half of what it looks like we have. But it looks impressive. I'm going to totally take ownership for that compared to other people who have done hangouts for the HPA. No, I won't. I'm not that horrible. I am kind of that horrible. I'm a pretty bad person. Should we waffle the cereal now? I think we should. I'm almost tempted to put milk with it because, like, the coffee worked out so well for the donut. That might be too soggy for cereal. And Maddie didn't say do milk. Maddie said cereal. And Maddie said Kix. Because Maddie's last name is Graham, which I think is really cool. I've always liked that as a name. Either a first name or a last name. I think it's a solid name. like that name. You guys, this waffle iron is just slipping and sliding all over my counter because there's cake batter and egg yolk everywhere, and it's just like, this is an episode of How to Basic at this point. Let's face it. It is How to Basic now. Also, update, my roommate's not coming home tonight. And she forgot to turn off her alarm in the morning, and she wakes up at like 5 a.m. So that'll be fun in the morning, but at least she won't accidentally see this mess tonight. All right, so we're really close to our goal. So you guys are awesome. Probably while we're doing this, we'll hit our goal, and then I have to eat all of this blenderized. Oh boy. All right. Well, let's waffle this cereal for Maddie first. I keep getting the wrong window open. I want to make sure you guys can see this. Okay. Ooh, did I put that in cake batter? Boy. Wait, it's not warm yet. Oops. I do that a lot. Hey. Let's see what everyone is saying on Twitter. All right. Claudia, the tweeting ghost, did put up my picture that I texted her. I don't know, it's playing well on our social media, but I thought it was cool. Yeah, it's totally not. Will It Waffle is not doing well on our social media tonight, so I really appreciate all of you guys who are here, who are enjoying this. For everyone who's been here all night, we're having a good time tonight. I am having fun with you all. Guys, don't search my name on Twitter. There's an inappropriate photo on there right now. It's not about me. I have TweetDeck, and so I have all these like saved hashtags and stuff. And currently is a unsavory photo of some woman I do not know in my tag. Well, it's not my tag. It's not Tumblr. Whatever. Hold on. I'm just gonna check. Oh, someone was watching from Chile. I was trying to say Chile, but like trying to pronounce it correctly. That was not, whatever. Someone was watching from Chile. That's so cool. And they have to go to sleep now because it's late. I think it's the same time. But thank you. Waffle a disc. Like a CD? I was going to do that one time. Sorry, I'm getting distracted with comments. Someone says this is the most fun they've had all week. Thank you. I think this is the most fun I've had all week, too. Mallory asks if I can do just one more thing and has some cool recommendations, but I don't think so, because we've been doing this for a long time. So I think we're going to do the cereal, and then we're going to do the blenderizing. If we hit our goal, we're not quite there yet. And then we'll probably call it a night, because I have to clean all of this. Re-waffle some of the blenderized waffle mix. Could do that. I could do that. Put the emphasis on could. All right, the waffle iron is warmed up, so let's do this. I'm gonna move my phone to safety. Let's turn the fan back on. I was trying to, what was happening right there is I was about to sing Bleachers. I stopped myself, but I kept dancing to it. I can't forget that you guys are here. Like, I think I'm aware that there's a camera, and I'm aware that you guys are all here, but every now and then throughout this live stream, I've thought that it's just recording a normal episode, just kind of subconsciously, and so I've been like, I'll edit this out later. Like, I can just do whatever I would usually edit out. But no, there's no pause button. You guys just been here the whole time. Wait, what time did I start this? 8:30? 9:30? 10:30? 11:30? Okay. Google Hangout kicks you off at a certain time. I wanted to make sure we're not going to hit that. Okay, can you see this? Let me turn this down so you can see. All right, this, maybe I should have put milk on there. This is, it's pretty dry. So, well, I think if we give it a little bit of time, the moisture from the heat and the cooking spray and stuff will actually make it do something. It might get kind of chewy. Let me know in the comments what you think is going to happen to this dry kick cereal. Should I even try this? Oh, I don't think it won't let me actually turn it because I can't close it all the way. Oh, I just remembered. Oh, I'm not supposed to use this waffle iron for things that aren't waffles. Oh, like the cake was one thing, but now I've done 3 waffles. There are so many things that you guys cannot tell my roommate, okay? All right. This one's going to take a while. Not much is happening here. So I'm going to go back to comments and checking out how the fundraiser is doing. Oh boy, we are $14 away from our goal, which is really just $7. For $7, you can get the With Flying Colors debut song. So that is Christina Horner, Lauren Fairweather, and Matt Majocco's brand new band. It's called With Flying Colors, and their very first single is being released through the fundraiser, which is super cool. Like, they could release that any way they want, and they're going to do it exclusively through our fundraiser. So that's pretty cool. That's $7. We only need $7 to get to our goal because there is the matching fund going on right now. But of course, if you wanted to donate $10, you could get 2 Will It Waffle buttons, which I will send to you. There, you'll get a happy and a sad, and I'll let you choose the colors. I hope I don't run out of sads. There are not as many sads as there are happies. But yeah, if just one of you bought one of those, that would put us over our goal, which means that I have to drink blenderized, waffled, weird things. Awesome. A waffle iron thinks that the cereal is done, but I'm going to leave that on there until I can hear it. It is starting to sizzle a little bit, so something will happen there. I just keep looking at my counter. It's just such a wreck. Oi. Oi, oi, oi. I'm trying to remember if there was anything I thought about, like, telling you guys tonight that I haven't said, like, any anecdotes or anything. I think I've basically said it. We are wearing on to that point of the night where I've kind of pulled everything out of my pockets. Whoa! We just got to 107,686. We have hit our goal. I think that means that someone probably donated something for $100. I don't know. It's not telling me yet. Or wait, no. I think just lots of people bought things. Got a Nerdfighter bundle and some bookmarks and the contest. Teamwork, that's what this was. That was teamwork. I have egg yolk on my hand. But we blew past that goal. Now I have to... now we're at 107,740. You guys, killing it tonight. Just totally killing it. Yeah, I think we've raised over $3,000 since I've been on. I think that's more than Harry and the Potter's raised. Although with the matching, we've only raised like 1,500, so I should not be so proud of myself. I want to be. You guys are just so great. Oh, you're the awesome buddies to have. I'm so happy. I'm having so much fun tonight with all of you here. I'm trying to refresh your comments, and they're not. Claudia says, if I ever needed to start a fire, I'll just waffle dry cereal. Excuse me, there is no fire happening. It's not even that much smoke. Whoa, 2 people from Chile were watching. Oh, Alyssa, you live in Chile? I remember your name all the time because your last name is Crowley. And so I'm always like, Downton Abbey? And then it's not. It's you. But I think of Downton Abbey when I see your name. Maddie mint with milk. Of course you did, because any normal person would assume. Should we add some milk now? Let's just add some milk. Okay, so this was Maddie's donation, so I'm doing everything Maddie tells me. Unfortunately, I just didn't assume this one. Oh yeah, see, that was not very fun. They're kind of burned. So here we go. Let me turn on the fan. It's cereal on waffle iron. There we go. These have shrunk. They've shrunk while they've been in here. Oh, now it's happening. So I made like a bowl of cereal in the waffle iron, and they're gonna get all soggy, and then it's gonna turn into a waffle, because that's what happens. Or maybe this will turn into funnel cake too. Wait, it was the other waffle iron that turned it into funnel cake, right? That waffle iron is specifically a magic funnel cake waffle iron. This is what I have determined via science, because it happened with that waffle iron, but it hasn't happened with the other waffle irons. So the waffle iron, not the ingredients, is the constant, and that's how that works. That's science. Wouldn't that be so cool though? Magic funnel cake waffle iron. This is doing more now. Sorry, can you see anything? Yeah, you can. Okay. Definitely smells like kicks. Like the smell is coming out a lot more powerfully now. That's smoking a lot. I don't want to set off the fire alarm. Okay, maybe it's time to look at what happened because it's smoking a lot. Whoa! It's like boiling. All right, hold on. I gotta unplug that. It's like moving really, really fast too. Oh, smoky. Smoke, smoke. They're just like shrinking. They were shrinking before I added the milk, but now the milk is just like boiling. Oh boy. Oh, it's so bizarre. It's just so strange. And like the science side of YouTube, tell me why it's moving faster. Like it's a really, really fast boil. It's almond milk with Kix cereal. Explain this to me. I feel like this is an answer, like a thing I could have answered in high school when I was up on my science facts, but now I don't have an answer. All right, so in the interest of not burning my apartment down tonight, I think that's as much as we're gonna waffle that. I would have kind of liked to see it like all sog into something that could turn into a waffle, but it's very smoky. It's very, very smoky tonight. So I think we're just gonna go ahead and dump that straight into the blender. Oh boy, thank you, Maddie, for adding this to the blender, because we do need some like liquid in there. So now we have this milk that can add to it. I might have to add some water, if we're being honest. But this is great. And there's just a big blob of chocolate cake batter with some Kix pellets in it over there. How wonderful. Wonderful that is. Can we get to 108,000 tonight? That would be really sick. I'd be really into that. I don't think I'm really gonna do anything if we get to that, except maybe leave you. But it would just be cool to get to a round number, you know? I'm just checking out all your tweets and seeing if anything's going on. Let me check out your comments, and we're gonna blender this soon. I'm looking forward to it. I'm not looking forward to it. What's your last name? Is that a question for me? My last name is Bird. My screen name, Lauren the Bird. Bird is name. I mean, the is not my middle name, but there's like upwards of 100 Lauren Birds in the world. Not even kidding. So Lauren Bird is taken on every social media platform.
But maybe you weren't talking to me. Maybe you were talking to someone else. I don't know. You guys just having your own chat down there, forming your own community. I'm cool with that. Oh, gosh, guys. This is ridiculous. Great. Blender. Oh. Okay. So how do we get... I'm definitely going to have to add water to this, or it's not going to, like, this isn't a great blender, and so it definitely needs the liquids to blend. Are you guys ready for this? Like, this is happening. Just didn't quite think through how to, like, this is the waffle iron, I can't lift it up, and it's very hot right now. Okay. I know, I'm getting kind of quiet right now, because I'm just trying to figure this all out. You should all be really loud in the comments to make up for it. Alright. This cereal is a lot soggier than I thought when I was first looking at it. I guess because the milk was boiling so much like that, so should have expected that. It is really funny how much it shrunk, though. So I wonder if we had kept it on longer, like if we had kept the dry cereal on longer, if it would have just, like, shrunk to nothingness. Alright. Ugh, keep thinking this top is gonna fall down on me, and it probably will. We're being realistic. Oh, I think I just got some soggy waffled kick cereal into my can of Surge. So, that's great. Alright, let's just try to... Oh, boy. You hear that squelching? Awesome. Okay. So that... We got the, waffled almond milk and kick cereal. And then... We also have the donut that turned into a funnel cake. Got some spaghetti. And got the cake. I just put a quarter of it. Maybe I'll just do half of it, because that's just really going to saturate it all. Although I probably want it to taste like chocolate, if we're being honest. Okay, so this is everything we're waffling in here. So this is, let me get the angle right. This is what equality looks like, basically. Everything equally blended together, except for the eggshells, because they're evil. And the cotton candy, because it disappeared. My hand is gross, gross, gross. We're going to add some water to this so that it will blend. I can't believe I'm doing this. The first time I said this, I did say I would just drink some, all right? I haven't fully committed to drinking all of it because, hot dang. I'm actually, you know what's actually, like, making me the most nervous about this is not doing this and not drinking it. It's having to make such a loud noise of blending at so late at night. So we'll do this quickly. That's why I wanted to add lots of water. So it'll blend. As I say that, I'm gonna add more. I just want it to, like, blend really quickly and be done with. Oh, gross. I got... I don't mind making a big mess, but everything I'm using that's my roommate's, like this blender, I just keep being like, oh, she's gonna kill me. Oh, man. I just got egg yolk and cake batter and spaghetti in my hair. Oh, do I have time to shower before my meeting tomorrow? Do you think professional partners will judge me if I show up with spaghetti in my hair? That'd be fine, right? Organization, if their spokesperson had spaghetti in their hair? Right? I think so. Okay, you guys ready? All right, that was, fortunately,
It mostly smells like the chocolate cake waffle. Oh boy. I'll put this in a. Oh no. I'm not gonna drink all of this because. Oh God. Oh, there are still chunks of spaghetti in here. Oh man. Oh, I don't know, guys. I mean, I'm gonna do it. I'm just trying to move my computer so that you can see and get a good angle here. Before I do this, let me just check what you guys are all saying as you've watched me blend this, resign myself to this fate. Oh, it's just a chocolate milkshake. It's just a chocolate milkshake. do do do. Da 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 da. Okay, so I was trying to just I was hoping that like comments or something would refresh enough to like see some moral support to feel better about doing this. I'm not seeing anything. Equality is a blended waffle without eggshells. Sounds like a Gandhi quote. Thanks, Megan. Add the almond milk and leftover coffee. Macy, why didn't I see that? That would have been way more canon to add the coffee. That would have been better. Add the coffee, add the yep, everyone was right. Hilda was gonna go to bed after the cotton candy, but now she's still here. Hilda, you should really go to bed. Karina says she can't donate. That is totally cool, Karina. Just totally like, spread the word, tell all your friends. That is it. Waffle of pumpkin. Funny you should say that. Stay tuned for next Wednesday. What? I don't what? Okay, I'm stalling. You ready? We're gonna taste this. You guys don't realize, like, I'm all alone right now. It feels really weird. Like, I don't have anyone here, like, laughing or egging me on or anything, so it just feels very strange. Okay. Oh, there's just a chunk of spaghetti at the top. Oh. Oh, okay. It does. Oh, it's the worst texture ever. Also, I'm chewing spaghetti. Oh. It's like still not going down. Okay, I'll take like two more sips just so we can really appreciate this. Does anyone who is watching watch I'm a Celebrity Get Me Out of Here? It's in the UK, it's on in the UK. I saw one person from England is watching. I know Jessica was watching at least at some point. Every year I watch I'm a Celebrity Get Me Out of Here and I see the food challenge and I'm always like, that is nothing. I would do it. I would just do it. This is changing my mind. Also, there's cake batter. All right. Okay, one more sip just to have like said that I've done it. One more sip. This is not happening. This whole no. Well, one more sip. Okay. 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 Oh my God. That's so gross. I can still feel it in my throat. Just doesn't go down well. I should have added the coffee. I think that would have helped. Oh, that was horrible. That was much worse than I thought it would be. I just have so much all over my hands. I can't touch my computer because I'm just covered in stuff. Oh, where is it? Water. I need water. Not coffee. Water. Need water. I need water right now. Where's my water? Okay. Well, thank you all for donating to make me do that. I hope it was worth it. I'm not sure if that was, but... worth it. Thank you for donating to Equality. Let me see what we're at now. We blew past every goal during this live stream. I really can't thank you guys enough. Like, it's been really, really incredible to see you all come together. And really, like, I mean, I work for the HPA, so it's great to see everyone donating for that. But from a Will It Waffle side, this has really meant a lot to me that so many of you have been watching this and buying the buttons and buying the Will It Waffle perk. And, like, everyone who I've met, like, has enjoyed Will It Waffle, and everyone who tells me online, too, like, dude, it means so much. It was just this wacky idea I had on New Year's at the start of this year, and it just completely changed 2014 for me. And I have so much fun, as you can tell from this night. I genuinely have so much fun doing this. Like, I really just do it because I love it, but... But the support from you guys, I mean, I wouldn't still be doing it probably if it weren't for the amazing response that it's gotten from all of you. I know I'm getting a little bit sappy right now, but it's just really, really cool to see the support from everyone who's like really constant, but then also there's just always new people like coming out of the woodwork saying, yeah, I've been watching for months, and I'm like, what? Dude, so cool. Yeah. Just means a lot. I don't even know how, I feel like I'm not articulating enough what it actually means to me. So just know that, like, it really does mean a lot. I think it's really cool. And in the future, there will be no more blenderized waffles. That is a fact. I'll just say that. So we're only like $50 away from 108,000, and I'm not. Some of you have said I should waffle that disgusting mess or something when we get to 108. I'm not going to, unfortunately. I'm just going to go. But I do want to see us hit 108,000, so I'm just going to kind of stay on and respond to some of your comments. If you guys have any questions, I guess, or anything like that, now's the time to ask, because I'm going to stay on for a few more minutes until we hit that 108. Just because I don't want to say bye to you guys yet, and I really want to see us hit that round number. Because we started, we think, around $104,400. So, I mean, really, I should stay on until we get to $108,400, then we would have made an even $4,000. But it's getting late, and I'm tired, and I have to clean my kitchen. So I just want to see us hit $108,000. So that's a nice round number. That'll be fun. So let's see, just check in if there's anything going on in the comments or on Twitter. Excuse me, getting burping up really gross things tonight. Really gross things. Board, who's watching from Australia. Maddie says she's fairly certain this is equivalent to some sort of polyjuice potion, not in a good magical way. I agree. Like, that is, when J.K. Rowling describes bad potions, and especially the way she describes polyjuice potion, that is exactly what that was like. And I actually can't think of a more apt description than that, now that I remember, like, how those were described in the books. Oh, yeah. Oh, wasn't it, like, when it's someone with kind of a gross personality, it was, like, a grosser potion? So that was... I don't know who that was. They're kind of sweet, but they have a bad aftertaste and they don't go down so well. Oh, don't say that. Don't read into what I just said. Are you gonna make Will It Waffle shirts or decals? I mean, I would love to. I'd love to have a Will It Waffle t-shirt. I haven't come up with like a cool design yet. And I don't know that Will It Waffle is quite there yet to have a lot of people to buy them to be able to, you know, offset the cost. of producing them and like have enough to even produce. But someday, yeah, if you guys keep watching Will It Waffle and keep spreading the word, maybe someday there will be t-shirts, because I would really like to have t-shirts. I think it would be fun. Yeah, everyone's saying you wish you could donate. Please don't feel obligated. I mean, I know the whole point is this is like a fundraiser and kind of telethon style, but if you can't donate, that's totally cool. You can still help out and support us by spreading the word, letting people know why it's a cause that you care about. You know, one thing that we really like to talk about is how being fan activists and the kind of work that you can do through the Harry Potter Alliance, it can really validate being a fan. You have a lot of people in your like IRL life who maybe scoff at like the fact that you are so passionate about your fandom. You know, you can use the HPA as an example. Use the kind of work that you've done with your chapter, with your members, or being a member, and tell them how you actually change the world by using fandom. I think I got on a tangent there, and some of you watching may not know too much about the Harry Potter Alliance. I'm kind of too tired now to tell you about it, if I'm being honest. But go to equalityftw.org and you can read all about our mission statement and what we've done in the past year and what we are hoping to do in the upcoming year. Yep. I wish YouTube and Google would get it together with comments, because they just come in such a weird order. I know there's the thing that's top comments and new comments. I always go to the new comments, but even when you do that, it like is still not quite correct, and it doesn't really update in real time, even when your internet connection is awesome. So maybe this milkshake was Pansy Parkinson when we're talking about it being Polyjuice Potion. Oh, Claudia says the Polyjuice Potion was gross because it was all the inequality we destroyed tonight. I like that. What's your favorite kind of waffle and waffle topping? I'm pretty classic. I like having some butter, or usually margarine, and some syrup on a normal waffle. That's honestly my favorite. I mean, my favorite is from Waffle House. I like to get a Waffle House waffle, or one that's like that. I like the thinner waffles with the small squares. Usually when I go to Waffle House, I get a chocolate chip waffle, but they changed how they do it. They used to bake them into the waffles, and now they just put a big glob of chocolate chips on top, which is not as fun. Or it's not as tasty. It's like, it's too much chocolate. You have to like scrape it off. So just the classic waffle is good for me. I do like, you know, Belgian style waffles, not the way Americans call them, but like authentic Belgian ones that you get like in a street cart, and they've got cool toppings and they're kind of like harder. I like those. There's a really good street cart that has those in New York City, and I like eating those. I also like stroop waffles, which are not waffles. they're more like biscuits, like cookies. Okay, let me check where we're at. Okay, we have not hit 108,000 yet. We're pretty much one donation away, because I think we're like $50 away, unless I'm doing my math totally wrong. And because they are matching grants tonight, that's really like $25 away. So it's possible my Indiegogo is just a little slow in updating. It's been doing that tonight, because a lot of people are donating, which is really great. A couple of people have asked how I got involved in the HPA. One person though also asked, Michelle Metzger, asked my favorite Harry Potter book. My favorite Harry Potter book is Prisoner of Azkaban. I think my second might be Order of the Phoenix. And then it gets really hard after that, because I really like all of them. They're pretty equal, but Prisoner of Azkaban is definitely my favorite. And I got involved in the HPA 4 years ago, actually. I had kind of been involved in the fan community just like online since, I mean, like 2002, really, like I was 12. Like Harry Potter has kind of always been the main thing I did on the internet, which is pretty cool to think about. But I didn't really know about the Harry Potter Alliance. I heard about them through the Vlogbrothers, because I was a big Vlogbrothers fan. I was always watching John and Hank's videos, and they mentioned a campaign
that they were doing with the Harry Potter Alliance to raise money for Haiti after the earthquake. And they rocked it, and all the Wizard Rockers all got together. And I was really impressed by that, so I kind of was like, wow, this Harry Potter Alliance thing seems cool. And they needed a video editor as a volunteer, so I did that. And I was their video editor and just kind of did a bunch of other stuff throughout college as like a volunteer and an intern. And then a year after I graduated, I started working full-time for the Harry Potter Alliance, and now I'm the communications director. So it's a weird full-time job, but it's really awesome and super rewarding, and mostly rewarding because of all of you who support us. That's like, I've had people ask me, like, you know, what's the coolest part about your job? And honestly, it's you guys, the stuff that you're able to accomplish, and the like support that you give us, and the way that you kind of just take our methodology and run with it, and like the ridiculous things that you do. Yep, getting sappy again. Megan says she wrote a research paper on the HPA changing the world recently, and her comp teacher was so inspired she became my university chapter's faculty advisor. That's awesome. That's really cool. Wow, congratulations. Must have been a good essay, too. Okay, how are we at 108 yet? I don't know, I'm just kind of fizzling out at this point. Really not. It's just like, that's like, you know, one Melissa and Ellie fanfiction away, pretty much, or a Maureen Johnson fanfiction, or a Starkid Harry Potter prequel. And then we'll get there. And then we'll all go to bed. Oh, now we're $12 away. All right, one more person buy a button. And then, oh, I'm getting so tired, I can't even talk. yeah, one more button, we'll be at 108. I just wanna go to bed having seen us hit 108. I think that would be lots of fun. I'm so sorry that the song has been stuck in my head all night and that I've not even been like singing or humming it correctly. almost there. That's definitely, I know that's not the song. Okay. I'm just reading Twitter. I know it's really boring to watch me read Twitter. $12 away! I know we're probably there, and it's just not, like, updating yet. I just want to see it happen. Also, I don't think I thanked Lizzie for buying some waffle buttons, so thank you for donating for those. Yeah, again, in these last moments, tonight's the only time that you can get waffle buttons online. For all the same reasons that I was just explaining about why there are no Will It Waffle t-shirts. production costs, unfortunately, don't weigh out yet, but I would love to see that happen someday. YouTube says that there's 5 comments on this live stream. It's so not true. Oh, okay. Here's a good way to end off the night. And probably while I'm talking, we will hit the goal if we haven't already. Let me refresh one more time. Oh, we hit it! $108,028. Thank you. Thank you to everyone who donated. Beautiful sight. I'm so excited. I'm so happy that we've all come together to make this happen. Thank you, Caroline, for buying some Will It Waffle buttons, and thank you to everyone else who's just picked up some Starkid prequels and stuff like that. So here's how I will end this. Dora asks, what made you think that you should waffle something? Did you just see something and think, hey, this would be good as a waffle? So here's how we're gonna end. I'm gonna answer this question. It's kind of the origin story of Will It Waffle. And then we're all gonna go to bed. I don't think any, maybe California people won't go to bed yet, but all the rest of us, it's quite late. I'm an old person. I go to bed at like 10:30. We're an hour past my bedtime. So, Will It Waffle. Ah, the early days. January 2014. So long ago. All right, so on like January 2nd,
I was feeling very inspired about the new year, and I was trying to think of some content for my YouTube channel. I was brainstorming a lot for the Harry Potter Alliance YouTube channel and for my own YouTube channel. Because, like, I just, you know what, I vlog about things, I just kind of talk about things that interest me, I make travel videos, I wanted something new to do. And I was writing them all down, and I was just kind of in that zone of, like, being inspired to come up with new things. And then I was on Tumblr after that, after working really hard to brainstorm, I went on Tumblr, and I saw this one post of someone put, I can't even remember exactly what it was now, they might have put, like, frozen hash browns or frozen tater tots onto a waffle iron and just kind of made, like, maybe they put tater tots on and made hash browns. I think that's probably what it was. And I saw that and I was like, oh, that looks kind of cool. And it reminded me of putting cinnamon rolls onto a waffle iron, like the Pillsbury kind that come in a can. And that's something I've actually been doing for years. I forgot when I first heard about it, but ever since I heard about it, that's just been the only way I make cinnamon rolls because it's far superior. Cook your cinnamon rolls on a waffle iron, not in the oven. It's quicker. I think it's more fun. You get the waffle. Of course, I think it's more fun. Who are you even talking to now? Like, you all know that I prefer things on waffles. Anyway, so I saw that and I was like, oh yeah, maybe I'll either do the cinnamon rolls because I already know that, or maybe I'll do this hash brown thing. And hey, I'll make a video out of it because I'm trying to come up with something for a video today. And then I thought about it a little longer and I was like, you know, I don't really feel like waffling either of those things. What if I waffle something else? And then I remembered that show, Will It Blend, and the CEO of BlendTech, has that YouTube channel that used to be like really, really popular, where to show how strong their blenders are, they would just blend random stuff like phones and iPads and all kinds of stuff. Sometimes food, usually not, like marbles, whatever. And I was like, how about I make a parody show of Will It Blend, but it'll be called Will It Waffle? And this was still on that same day, on January 2nd, I was just coming up with all this stuff. And I like went out and I bought some safety goggles and like 10 Snickers bars, and that day I just waffled Snickers bars and made the first horrible logo and ripped off the Will It Blend music and just put it together and wasn't sure if anyone would like it, but they did, and I was like, all right, then I'm just gonna do it for a while and just see what happens. But it was like kind of in that one day I had the idea and just planned out everything for Will It Waffle. Like in that one day I brainstormed like 50 different things I could waffle and people I could collab with and things I could do in the future once it started like kind of taking off and being more of a thing. It was just a very creative day. I don't know. This was the most rambly way I could have possibly told you that, but I have been standing and waffling things for many hours, so that was an incredibly roundabout way to tell that story, and I apologize it was so long, but that's pretty much the origin story of Will It Waffle. Excuse me. And now I am going to sign off. So I'm just checking a couple more comments in case there's anything I want to respond to before I sign off. I think it's time for bed. I've got to clean all of this. Witches of Us has a research paper due in the morning. I'm sorry. I wish I could help you with that, but I can't. But good luck, everyone. Wish them good luck on the research paper and anyone else doing homework. Yeah, thank you all so much for donating. The fundraiser is continuing until Saturday, and we're going to have a hangout on Saturday to kind of end it. It ends at midnight California time, so that's like 3 a.m. East Coast time. So we're going to probably a really late hangout, probably. That's what we usually do. Just kind of ride it out. Friday, Tessa Netting is going to be doing a hangout for Equality for the Win. That's going to be early in the afternoon, so you can kind of do it like when your classes are over but you haven't gone out with your friends yet. You can tune in to Tessa's hangout, and that'll be a lot of fun. But yeah, there's only a couple more days left to donate, and a lot of these perks are things that are never going to come back ever again, especially any of the signed posters or any of the exclusive material or the t-shirts. Like, this is the only time you can get them in the calendar, the Puppets of YouTube calendar. And that's all brand new material. We just shot all of those photos in August. So that's all brand new and only during Equality for the Win. So definitely donate, and of course it is for a good cause, and please do spread the word for the next couple of days to any of your friends, family, anyone you think might be interested, and just let them know, you know, why it matters to them. You know, why are you tuning in tonight besides waffles? Why does equality in education or the economy or LGBTQ equality matter to you? And why does it matter to you about fans coming together and being activists and being fan activists? Yeah. Those are all important things that I haven't talked about too much tonight, but I talk about a lot usually. Okay, I'm gonna go to sleep now. I've had an absolute blast with you guys tonight. And thank you for donating, and thank you for supporting Will at Waffle and for supporting the HPA and Equality for the Win. And you're all beautiful little waffles.